Thank you, Dave. Welcome to Chili Logan. Utah State and Brigham Young, first possession. Chucky Keaton running the offense for Utah State. Keaton going deep as a man, Robinson, and he just missed him. Devontae Robinson in the pattern. First possession of the football game. And the story here is that it is Chucky Keaton starting at quarterback. Kent Myers, who came in for Keaton earlier in the season and has played so well, is not available with a shoulder injury. Adam, how does that affect Utah State and Brigham Young defensively?
Well, here's the good thing. Utah State, the seniors and the members of this football team have a lot of trust in Keaton. He's won a lot of games, and they know that he has what it takes to run this offense against that Cougar team.
And there he goes, Keaton to the 10. He scores 48 yards. Utah State goes 75 yards, an impressive drive with Chucky Keaton at the controls.
Well, it's what he brings to the table. Maybe not quite the runner is in the quarterback run game that Kent Myers brought to the table. But you can see Chucky Keaton, who's had all those knee injuries in his career, keeping the ball on the zone read, fooling the defense, and getting a big play on their first series.
What a statement by Utah State. Yeah, the extra point, movement, and flags. There are a lot of in-state rivalry games across college football. Today, Brigham Young and Utah State, not really a rivalry, so to speak, until the last 5 or 6 years, as Utah State's
offside, number 91 of the defense. After this is 2-0, try for point.
As Utah State's program has gotten better, and of course, last year, for the first time since 1978, Utah State went down to Provo and not only shocked Brigham Young, but beat them badly.
They did, and offensively, Utah State played a pretty brilliant game. Daryl Gerritsen was the quarterback, threw for 321 yards, 3 touchdowns. Nick Vigil had a big game. Hunter Sharp had a big game. And here in the first series of this one, another big play, a great start.
As to who would play quarterback for Utah State. That question has been answered. Chucky Keaton, 52 yards later, Utah State is on top, 7-0. Bronco Mendenhall and Brigham Young now knows that it's Chucky Keaton. Adam Archuleta, what'd you see on the play?
Well, everybody up front, this is the challenge of playing the zone read, but everybody up front is playing the run. This linebacker has to get outside and play Chucky Keaton on the quarterback keeper. You have his safety out there, Kai Nakua, coming up. He's in a big bind. He has to play the pitch man, and he has to play Keaton. Nobody comes over to play the quarterback and show and Chucky Keaton showing what kind of speed he has.
There's the drive, 75 yards. And again, there was a question whether it would be Keaton or whether it would be Kent Myers. Myers injured his shoulder early against Nevada last week. Keaton led the comeback. Myers, we are told, is not available to play in the ballgame. And that kick scoots through the end zone. And so Brigham Young starts their first possession from the 25-yard line. A chilly, somewhat snowy day here in Logan, Utah. Tanner Mangum. And the freshman will bring him out. Chick-fil-A brings you the starting lineups. Well, Mangum certainly has had a terrific year.
Now he has, and Rich, when you watch him play, he gets better and better every game. Last week he threw for his fourth career 300-yard passing game, 336 yards against Fresno State. Now, they started out a little slow. The key for them, especially after being down by 7 points, is to get some rhythm early.
Mangum. It was a rhythm pass. It was a low one. And Mitch Matthews, who's one of the big receivers for BYU, was down to get it. So it's an 11-yard pickup and a first down for Brigham Young. Offense, a lot of weapons, but everything revolves around that offensive line. Riker Matthews, the leader up there.
Well, they've had some issues offensively with the line, a lot of injuries, but here They have a pretty good starting five, and they're going to have a big game against a very physical Utah State front.
Algernon Brown with the carry, and Brown is out to the 45-yard line. Now defensively, very good defense for Utah State. We talk about linebackers. Nick Vigil can play on both sides of the ball.
He is all over the field. 131 tackles this year, 3 sacks, 12 and a half tackles for a loss, and he loves to penetrate, gets downhill, and make tackles in the backfield.
This is a BYU offense that had a big week last week. And a throw to the side. Bernard with the catch, and he's hit and dropped. Marwin Evans with the hit, and short of the first down, it'll be third down and less than a yard.
Now, big time tackle, big time hit from the senior strong safety, Marwin Evans. He's the run stopper in this defense. And when we talked to Robert and I, the offensive coordinator, talking about getting that fast start, third downs. Last week, only 2 third down conversions in that first half against Fresno State. They've got to be able to convert and sustain this drive and get something going.
And Brigham Young right now is going to take a timeout.
Timeout. BYU. First charge timeout of the half.
One of the things that Brigham Young has to deal with is a very good Utah State defense. And we talk about linebackers. We just touched on Nick Vigil. Kyler Fackrell is another one. This is a really good front seven.
Yeah, one of the best, most versatile defenders you're going to find in the Mountain West. And to kind of show you what he can do, I'm going to show you the LG V10 eye vision to see what he brings to the table. He has great instincts to understand how its offenses are trying to attack. Disengages off of the block, makes the solo tackle in the backfield. But he's not just the one-trick pony. The passing game is also a place where he excels. Again, instinctually, understanding what the offense is trying to do, navigating in traffic, and making that one-on-one tackle. Again, Kyler Fackrell is one of the most versatile defenders. This is a guy that has a chance to play on Sundays.
And he has a long, long resume. 5 fumble recoveries that leads the nation, 4 sacks, 13 and a half tackles for loss. One of the best, if not the best defensive player in the Mountain West Conference. 3rd and inches for Brigham Young. Pistol work for Mangum. And they hand it off to Brown, and he powers forward and gets the first down to the 47-yard line. Nick Vigil on the stop for Utah State.
It's a good run by Brown, understanding he has to get just inches. And that was a major head-on collision inside by Nick Vigil. One-on-one, running back versus linebacker. Algy Brown gets the first down.
BYU hung 52 points on the board against Fresno State last week. First and 10, their own 47. Mangum rolling right, throwing, and on the mark there, Nick Kurtz, part of the squadron of very talented and big wide receivers for BYU.
Well, they do this a lot on offense. Tanner Mangum loves to escape to his right. And I don't know why more defensive coordinators don't send pressure off of his right side, because when he escapes to the right, that's when his wide receiving core uncovers and makes plays in the passing game.
First and 10, BYU on the move. Utah State went 75 yards in their first possession. Now he's rolling left and throwing down the sideline. Almost a great catch. Matthews coming back. DeShane Hines on the coverage. And that's a matchup to watch. The diminutive corners against the big receivers.
Boy, this is close. I don't know if Matthews, he might have been able to come down with this.
That's worth looking at again.
A big question. I think Matthews, his knee came down before he was able to secure the catch on the sideline. But I think
previous
this is one they're going to have to look at.
Pass is under further review.
So they will take a look at it. Here's a look. Did he have possession? Did he get a foot down? That right foot looks like it clips inbounds as he's going out.
Well, watch his knee. It looks like the knee and the foot kind of hit simultaneously right there. That is awfully close, but a terrific adjustment down the field. And that's kind of what you've seen from Matthews the entire season. That ability to turn his body around and come down with those contested catches.
You talk to coaches around college football, and they'll tell you that Mitch Matthews is one of the best in the country at winning the battle for the ball. When it's a jump ball, when he has to go get it, he is one of the very best.
Strong hands. His catch radius is ridiculous. 6'6", 215 pounds. And boy, that I don't know how you call this one.
Ooh, it has to be definitive. You know, the one thing you look for, watch that right foot. Watch, see if it drags and kicks anything up right there.
You know, I think that this might be ruled a catch, because that right toe, it looked like the toe and the knee simultaneously hit the ground at the same time. The knee was out of bounds. The toe was in bounds.
If it stands, it's a 32-yard completion. Eddie Shelton, our referee. The sun has arrived here. This was a nasty morning. Temperatures in the low 20s, lots of snow. They worked to get the snow off of the field. There's still some snow on the field, but the sun is out. Temperatures in the upper 20s. And BYU is reacting like it's a catch. You could see Matthews. And the Brigham Young offense is rushing down the field to line up as if this is going to be good. What a play by Mitch Matthews.
After review, the ruling on the field is a completed catch at the 8-yard line. And the BYU first and 10, first and goal at the 8. Clock operator, please reset the game clock to 10:23.
Well, how about that?
There you go. Now the Cougars responding with a big play offensively of their own, trying to answer that very first touchdown by the Aggie offense. And that was a matter of centimeters. That right toe, that right toe getting down just before his knee hit out of bounds. Again, a terrific adjustment by Matthews.
Verizon Red Zone, Brigham Young is the best in the country in the red zone at getting points. 12th in the country in getting touchdowns in the red zone. First and goal from the 8. This is Algernon Brown. Right side, touchback into the end zone. And Brigham Young answers. After the great catch by Matthews, Algernon Brown completes an impressive drive. And both offenses have gone length of the field for scores.
A great job up front by the center, Tijon Caroma, and Riker Matthews sliding down, playing a little bit of left guard, getting the seal block and allowing that space for Brown to pick up the touchdown.
And the point is good. What is becoming a really fun rivalry in Logan today, Mitch Matthews got the foot down, and BYU is in and even with Utah State. Seven, Brigham Young, Utah State, here in Logan, a sellout crowd. Our icy hot injury report: Kent Byers injured his shoulder last week against Nevada, left after the second series, and we've seen Chucky Keaton in there. And so that is your icy hot injury report. Chucky Keaton engineered a nifty drive. In fact, the last 52 yards were all Keaton. On a keeper on the right side and an option. He went 52 yards for a touchdown. Brigham Young, his answer, 7-7.
What did Matt Wells say yesterday? That maybe Keaton was a little bit rusty coming in last week because he didn't play a lot, but didn't show a lot of rust on that very first series of the game.
Kennedy Williams from his goal line, Utah State. Williams to the 23-yard line. And that's where he will mark it. Rich Waltz, Adam Archuleta. Cassie Gallo is with us. Cassie, what went into the decision between Keaton and Myers?
Yeah, I talked to head coach Matt Wells right before the game. He said, we started with Chucky, we're going to end it with Chucky. He's been the leader on this team, so maybe he'll get that storybook ending that he deserves. Coach also said he's feeling great today, very confident. And what a way to start after that touchdown. Chucky ran over to the sideline, got mobbed by his teammates and coaches, walked over to the offensive linemen, gave every one of them a fist bump. Also, Coach talked all week about this game and how it's evolving into a big rivalry. Before the game, I asked him what a win would mean today. He said everything, absolutely everything. It'll be the first time we beat BYU in back-to-back years in 41 years, Rich.
All right, thank you, Cass. He also admitted to us that this really wasn't that much of a rivalry until about 5 or 6 years ago when the program here took a real upswing. And, of course, last year sealed it when Utah State went down to Provo and beat BYU. BYU had an undefeated season going. And, of course, that was a ball game in which Taysom Hill, their fine quarterback, was injured as well. Second down and 7 for Utah State. And Keaton will hand it off. Devontae Mays out to the 28-yard line. That's a gain of 4. It's 3rd down and 3. All right, offensively, certainly we talk about the weapons that Keaton has on the outside, but Devontae Mays, their fine running back, has had a nice year.
It finally got a chance to get loose a little bit last week. A career high, 22 carries for 133 yards, 2 touchdowns in that game, and he's really starting to find himself. They really feel like he can be a workhorse-type running back in this offense here today.
3rd down 3. Luan Hunt in motion, Keaton by himself. Little inside shovel to Wyatt Houston, and the big tight end lumbers out to midfield. Creative play calling, nicely executed by Chucky Keaton.
Well, perfect play because Bronco Mendenhall dialed up the blitz off of that left side. Harvey Longy, number 21, the linebacker, going outside, and then the offensive line just washing down the defensive front, and Wyatt Houston coming through with a big gain.
18 yards, and the ball sits right at midfield. On first and fumble, ball's loose. Who's got it? Brigham Young on the scene. Hunt was the first one there. And Utah State will lose 5 but gets it back.
Here's that play right there. You see both players, Kafusi and Longy, coming outside. That's what opens up the extra gap on the inside. And a good job of play calling by Josh Heupel, the offensive coordinator, to catch the Cougars off guard.
Still maybe a little rust with the Chucky Keaton. Remember, Keaton injured his knee, that knee that has been so troublesome. That was at Washington. That's when Kent Myers took over and played very, very well. Keaton played the second half of the game against Nevada and led Utah State to a comeback win. 2nd down. Keaton scrambling. And throwing incomplete. The ball slipped out of his hand. Travis Tuiloma and Bronson Kafusi were in pursuit. And it'll bring up a long 3rd down. Here's the defense for Brigham Young. We talked about Kafusi. He's the guy that's going to be playing next year on Sundays.
There's a big-time defensive line, and Bronson Kafusi is the headliner. 10 sacks this season, and has done such a great job pass rushing that they haven't had to bring a lot of pressure so far this season. But the one part of the game he brought this year was his ability to play physical in the running game. He's a complete player.
3rd down 14 for Utah State. He's got some room, and he's got the 1st down. That's a 16-yard pickup for the sophomore out of Fort Lauderdale, Luan Hunt.
Well, Hunt picks up a great block by his left tackle and another terrific block on the perimeter by his wide receiver. I can't quite see what number receiver it was that gave the block right there on the cornerback, Michael Davis, but Hunt showing some good movement right there and picking up a big 3rd down on the ground.
Motion man is Robinson. 1st and 10, and Keaton goes down. And it's Travis Tuiloma, the junior nose tackle.
Well, we talked a lot about Bronson Kafusi and what he brings to the table, but the other guy on this defensive line is the nose tackle, number 91, Travis Tuiloma. He is maybe one of the best nose guards that BYU has ever had.
And if they want to run the ball inside, you don't really see a lot of pass rush from him inside, but a good job of beating the center and getting to Keaton.
That is a 10-yard loss, second down and 20. On the ground, Devontae Mays. He's going to lose yardage. Tomasi Laulile, the sophomore out of Westlake, California, on the stop.
Well, Rich, one thing, when you watch this defense, this front seven is pretty outstanding. And they're one of the best in the nation in a lot of different categories. Sacks, getting to the quarterback, tackles for loss. And this is something that this offensive line is going to have to handle today. You've already seen on this drive two big-time negative plays putting Utah State in a bad situation.
Third down and 22. Keaton escapes and throws complete at the 33-yard line. Hunter Sharp came back to get the football. He's going to be short of the first down. But at the 32-yard line, you're right on the border as far as field goal. Jake Thompson's longest in his career is 52 yards. And this is going to be close to a 50-yarder. And certainly it's not easy to kick when the temperatures are in the high 20s. So Thompson from 49. It's blocked. It lands at the 5 and rolls into the end zone. And Brigham Young with a nice stop. Logan Taele looked like he got a hand on it.
I think that was Bronson Kafusi, the big 6'8 defensive end, getting his hands up. Rich, that's the sixth block kick of this season by this BYU Cougar special teams.
7-7 in Logan.
College football on CBS Sports Network is being brought to you by Icy Hot Smart Relief TENS Therapy. Turn off pain. By Acura. Discover the 2016 Acura lineup at Acura.com. And by Sonic's new Ultimate Chicken Sandwich.
That was the look early this morning. The snow has been cleared. The sun is out. Temperatures are still chilly. Brigham Young with their second possession. Tanner Mangum, redshirt freshman quarterback, on play action. Lights rolling right. Well, fires that one into the Utah State bench. Mitchell Juergens out on the pattern.
A really good job by the secondary here for the Aggies. And the one thing, when Mangum goes to his right and when he tries to extend the play, the one thing his wide receivers do, almost better than anybody in the country, they turn into a scramble drill. And if you're deep, they go short. If they're short, they go deep. And if they go right, they go left. So you have to do a great job of keeping your eyes on the receiver and not allow Mangum to get to his receivers as they uncover.
Second down and 10. Algernon Brown. And Brown with a flag down has the first down. He's out to the 44. The flag came late and it came near the tackle.
Well, they might get Remington Peck.
Holding number 44 of the offense. 10-yard penalty from the previous spot. We play second down.
And that is Remington Peck.
Yeah, Remington Peck came over from the defensive line right about midseason. You're going to see him right here. Peck, as Brown gets to the outside, you're going to see that left arm just wrap right around the defensive end right there. But Remington Peck, as I was saying, came over from defensive line, and they brought him over to give this offense a blocking presence at the tight end position. And he's really done a nice job in just four or five games playing that position.
Well, his defensive line mates would tell you he came over to the offense to throw touchdown passes, which is what he did last week.
That too.
In the win against Fresno State, after they suggested it to play to Robert Anai, their offensive coordinator. Quick throw. Juergens has the catch, and he's bounced out of bounds at the 26-yard line. There is Anai, who was an offensive lineman at Brigham Young. He talked about the trick play.
His inside receiver suggested it to him, and he said, just to get him off his back, he said, all right, let's run it once. And it worked in practice. And he called it the game, and it worked for a touchdown. Remington Peck hit to earn help for that score. Third down, 16. Mangum with time. Deep ball, and it is in a group and caught. Kurt Henderson. Incredible. Two defenders. Henderson, the senior, comes down with it.
I have no idea how this even happens. And Kurt Henderson, another one of these wide receivers, but you see the safety, Marwin Evans, come over. He has a chance at interception. I have no idea how Henderson comes down with that ball. I mean, this wide receiving core, Rich, is something else. Every single week, it's somebody else making a big play for this Cougar offense.
38 yards on the completion, first and 10. Mangum, a little inside pattern. Henderson, the catch, smelled out nicely by that Utah State defense.
Caleb Davis with the tackle on Kurt Henderson. Brings up a second down. Second down and nine.
Well, this is, now these aren't all the names. We couldn't fit them all on the same page, but just the headliners.
Every week, you see how many wide receivers here have over 500 yards, how many have over 400 yards, and every week it seems like it's somebody else making a big play for this offense. Very challenging for a secondary to key on who you're trying to throw the ball to.
Second and nine. This one is for Kurtz. Nick Kurtz has it, but is out of bounds. Kurtz at 6'6". And he ends up in a snowbank, but with the football.
It's pretty evident, again, in this game, how the Cougars want to attack. Downfield passing, one-on-one passing. They stretch the field and put a lot of stress on defensive secondaries.
Mangum early, 7 of 9, 98 yards. This is third down and nine. Flushed right. Deep ball. Hauk. And it's incomplete. There's a flag down at the 10. Taron Hauk was locked up in coverage there with Bryant Hayes. And this will be a first down for BYU.
Boy, big call right there on third down. And one of the things that Matt Wells and Kevin Kloon, the defensive coordinator, said they wanted to do is get Mangum to throw the ball off balance. You're going to see right there at the end of the play, Bryant Hayes puts his hands on Hauk, but that ball was badly underthrown. I think that's calling it pretty close right there, Rich.
Is that an uncatchable ball? We normally relate that to an overthrow, not an underthrow.
That ball was well underthrown. Look, I guess technically it was pass interference, but that's a pretty close call.
Mangum upended, and he slides down at the 22. He's going to lose to Jordan Nielsen, the senior.
Big time play over there on that right side by Jordan Nielsen, and he beats the right tackle, Lapuaho, inside and gets to Mangum. And I think that's going to have to be the key today. If you get pressure off of Mangum's right side and make him go to the left, now I think you have a chance. But when he buys time scrambling, that's when you see him go downfield and make those big plays.
Second down and 12. Just outside the 20. Mangum on the run. Out the catch. And DeShane Hines comes up from his corner spot. Another flag goes down. This one at the 18-yard line on the other side of the field.
Ineligible player downfield. Number 56 of the offense. 5-yard penalty. We play second down.
Tejon Karoma, a sophomore out of Allen, Texas. He moves the football back to the 27-yard line. Marco Mendenhall, his 11th season. Brigham Young has been very successful in his tenure. They've been to a bowl game and are certainly headed there again this year in all 11 of his years.
Heavy screen look right here. Five receivers to one side.
Mangum setting, throwing. End zone, broken up. Another jump ball. Nick Kurtz. And it was Hines who made the play.
Rich, this is exactly what you have to do. DeShane Hines runs about 5'10", and he's going up against a 6'5" wide receiver. He's not going to out-jump him, but as he comes down with the ball, you have to be able to play that pocket and pry those arms away from the football. That is a perfect job, very technical, by the senior cornerback making a big play down the field.
Third down, 17. 7-7, Brigham Young here in Logan against Utah State. Algernon Brown on a draw, and he's going to end up between the hash marks, but well short of the first down. That should set up a field goal attempt for the Cougars. And they have a good one in Trevor Sampson, who's had a fine year. He's 13 of 15, and this is going to be for 41 yards. Remember, Brigham Young blocked a field goal attempt earlier in this first quarter. Utah State has blocked four kicks this year themselves. This one is off cleanly, and it's good. And Brigham Young has their first lead of the day. The sun is out on a chilly day at Logan, and BYU is up three. Full house in Logan, and they're enjoying some sunshine right now. Brigham Young, a 10-7 lead. Time to go RVing, our road trip facts. It's 125 miles north from Provo to Logan. And there's your size comparison. And we've talked about it, Anna Marcelletta. Brigham Young, certainly a powerhouse in this state. They and Utah had such a traditional rivalry in the same conference for many years. That ended about 5 years ago. And this has started to develop into an in-state rivalry.
It really started with Gary Anderson building up this program. And when he took off and left for Wisconsin, Matt Wells did equally as an impressive job taking over the reins and continuing to build this football program. And now I think, you know, they're starting to attract a pretty good type of athlete here in Logan, Utah, and proving that they can, in fact, compete with the bigger schools in the state.
Hunter Sharp is deep, along with LaJuan Hunt. And a short kick. And Utah State is going to end up with great field position. And here comes Chucky Keaton again. If you're just joining us, Keaton getting the start. This has been a mercurial career. What a great start to his career. And then two catastrophic knee injuries, short-circuited two seasons. This year he was the starter, and he sprained his knee against Washington. But last week off the bench, rallied his team to a win, and he gets the start here. We were told that Kent Myers is not available with that shoulder that he injured against Nevada. It's a great field position on the short kick. Utah State, their own 45. Hayes. And it's Tui Loma. He's in the backfield. And it's a tackle for a loss of half a yard.
It's going to be a tough matchup. Boy, Tui Loma just ragdolled the center, Austin Stevens. And again, you saw a little bit in that last drive for Utah State. They had a hard time with the BYU defensive front. And I think if they want to have offensive success, they're going to have to find a way to block that front three of BYU.
Well, Brigham Young fell down early and impressively has a 10-7 lead. We head to the second quarter in Logan next. Second quarter ready to go. Bronco Mendenhall has always had a great defense. Heck, he's the defensive coordinator. He's got to be happy with his first quarter.
Bad first series, but they started to get on track in the second series. Their big two up front, Bronson Kafusi and Travis Tui Loma, making a big impact there. Flushing Chucky Keaton, Tui Loma coming up inside, getting a sack, and then dominating the line of scrimmage and a tackle for a loss. If they can't find a way to contain number 90 and 91, it's going to be a very long day offensively for Utah State.
Mendenhall was a safety and a linebacker at Oregon State before starting his coaching journey, which took him from Corvallis, Albuquerque, to Provo. Second down, 10. Utah State, their own 45. Keaton's throw right at midfield. Wyatt Houston, the intended receiver, and he couldn't hold it. It'll bring him third down and 10.
Really good job by the outside linebacker, Fred Warner, coming up and making that play. And, boy, I think Fred Warner is one of the more underrated members of this defense, Rich. And he's been all around the ball here in the second half of the season. Made some real critical plays. Really good job of breaking up on that pass.
Third down, 10. Little inside screen. And a catch there. And a first down. Andrew Rodriguez, the junior, into Brigham Young territory to the 44-yard line.
Good play call and a really good job by the left side of that offensive line. Tyshawn Mosley and Ben Wysocki getting out in space and making the key blocks to pick up that first down.
Well, it is a little different look with Chucky Keaton back there. Myers, a great runner, maybe a little more explosive as a runner. Keaton, though, has a 52-yard touchdown run in this ball game. First and 10 at the Brigham Young 43. Keep it on the ground. And struggling for that extra yard is Juan Hunt. Tomasi Lalile made the stop for BYU.
Eris, going back and talking about the differences in these quarterbacks, the thing is, both quarterbacks can run. Certainly Keaton has dynamic open field running ability, but Kent Myers was that traditional running quarterback where they actually ran plays. Quarterback power up inside, quarterback lead up inside. Keaton is more of a finesse runner, hitting the zone reads and also making things happen in the passing game when things start to break down.
Second down, 9. Keaton pulls it and fires a strike right at the 29-yard line. Caught there by Kennedy Williams, the junior out of Las Vegas.
And not a lot of rust here. And another good job by Keaton using that zone read to pull up the linebacker, Austin Heater, and then throwing that accurate pass to his slot back, Williams.
13 yards on the pickup for Williams, just his 6th catch of the season. Mays in the backfield. Utah State on the move. Inside the BYU 30. Keaton again, another point. And this one caught. Brandon Swindle.
Keaton's pass complete to Brandon Swindle.
At the 18. Micah Hanneman on the coverage, another first down.
Rich, you notice what Josh Heupel, the offensive coordinator, is doing on this drive, quick passing game. This is the third or fourth quick pass that we've seen from Keaton. On the previous drive, more drop back passing, and that allowed BYU's defense to get to him. So you're seeing great timing by Keaton and his wide receivers coming down with a catch and moving the offense down the field.
Yeah, that is Josh Heupel, the former Oklahoma All-American and national champion. Keaton pumps. And throws. And it's incomplete. Houston, his tight end in the coverage, was Michael Wadsworth. And his safety.
There's a couple plays ago. You're going to see down here having some issues kind of getting lined up. A little bit of communication issues. But Brandon Swindle, they figure it out. Keaton spots him and gets him the ball.
Now that's senior leadership from Swindle, the senior from Oklahoma City. Chucky Keaton and Utah State face with second down and 10. On the ground, Devontae Mays. It's tough running. We talk so much about that front three, but when you get through the linebackers, there are some tough customers in that linebacking quartet.
I think the one place where Utah State has to get better is the red zone, Rich. Only 54% of their trips in the red zone have resulted in touchdowns. And that's come back to hurt them in some key games this year and some key tight games. And when you talk about BYU, this is a tough defense. And they don't allow you to run the ball. And then the passing lanes also get condensed here. So they're going to have to figure out a way to scheme something up to pick up this first down. Third down and six. And I think that was Matt Wells that dashed down to get a timeout, racing down the sideline.
Timeout. Utah State. First charge timeout of the half. 30-second timeout.
So third down and six for Utah State, trailing by three against Brigham Young. Tomorrow, a great way to finish off your holiday and all the leftovers. NFL on CBS doubleheader, highlighted by Jets, Dolphins, Steelers, Seahawks. Check your local listings. Beginning with your Super Bowl 50 team, JB, Tony, Bart, Coach, and Boomer on the NFL Today, presented by Southwest Airlines. If you want a Super Bowl tie-in to this one, well, you can go Jim McMahon, certainly, who was a reserve on that Packer team that won a Super Bowl and, of course, led the Bears to what was a historic Super Bowl win. Utah State now on a third down and six. They're 4 of 5 on third down today. Adam Archuleta, what would you dial up?
Well, it's empty formation, so you got to be alert for a quick passing game. Slants or outs by the two slot receivers is what you got to watch out for.
Brigham Young with a three-man front, and they bring three. Keaton has time and fires an out, and it's dropped. Hunter Sharp doesn't drop many, but he dropped that one.
Yeah, and that's one that he has to have. Maybe the ball was a little bit low, but Hunter Sharp had room to run. He was running away from the inside linebacker trying to cover him. The outside receiver did a good job of turning up to block, and that was a sure first down conversion, maybe a touchdown if Sharp is able to catch that pass.
And there is no wind. And so Jake Thompson, who from 49 had a kick blocked by Bronson Kafusi. And as Adam pointed out, 7 block kicks that leads. And that one off an upright. Well, field goal kicking for Utah State has been a trouble spot the last two games. And they are 0 of 2 in this one. First one was blocked. This one hits an upright. And Brigham Young hangs on to the lead. Chucky Keaton has a long touchdown run. Tanner Mangum has looked sharp. Utah State has missed 2 field goals, and it's 10-7 BYU. Enterprise gives us our pick to watch. Arch?
Well, it's going to be a big matchup today. Mitch Matthews, obviously, we've already seen his impact down the field, had that big reception. And then on the other side of the ball, Jalen Davis is their best cover corner. He's got to have a big day today, and so far, they've been using DeShane Hines to cover Matthews. I think they've got to change that.
Algernon Brown with the carry, and he's going to gain 1 painful yard. Nick Vigil, the original hit. Marwin Evans finished him off. And it's 2nd down and 9. There's a look at Evans. We talked about Nick Vigil, Kyler Fackrell. The front 7 for both of these teams. Very, very good. Although we haven't seen Vigil in the offensive backfield yet. He had 4 carries. And in this game last year, it was the first time that Utah State used him on both sides of the ball. He played over 100 snaps. Mango, scramble, downfield, open man. Blackman can't hold it. Marwin Evans caught up to him.
Well, one thing you can't do is you can't let Mangum get outside of you, and that's what Kyler Fackrell did, and that allowed Mangum time to try and throw the ball downfield to Blackman. Now, that should be a catch, but just a great job of recovering after getting beat and making that play to negate the catch.
3rd down, 9. Blitz coming. Mangum flush, sets. Another deep ball, another battle, and it's incomplete. No flags. The BYU bench was hopeful that Mitch Matthews was interfered with. But no call. But they love sticking to their philosophy. How many passes over 15, 20 yards have we seen so far here today? And they had a little bit of success, but right now the Utah State secondary doing a good job of breaking up those passes down the field. So I think you might have to reassess your strategy a little bit if you're Robert and I, the offensive coordinator, and maybe go to a quick passing game to try and keep the drive going.
Short punt, and Rodriguez will field it at the 42-yard line. And good field position for Utah State. The Aggies have missed a pair of field goals. They get the football with 10:21 left in this first half in Logan. All right, thank you, Brent. In Logan, and yeah, if Michigan State wins that ball game, not only would they face Iowa in the Big Ten championship game, Adam Archuleta, they would win the Land-Grant Trophy. Now, this is played for the wagon wheel. Utah State and BYU, a lot of rivalry games today and a lot of odd trophies and things that teams are playing for. First and 10, Utah State, their own 41. Chucky Keaton at the controls. To the sideline, man open. A juggling catch. Tyler Fox. And he's out of bounds at the 34-yard line. But that was close. Fox trying to get 1 foot in.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised if they look at this one because his right foot was awfully close to that sideline.
No call down from the replay booth. Utah State hurries to the line of scrimmage. 25 yards on the catch. First and 10 at the BYU 34. Utah State has moved the football, but they've missed two field goals in this one. Devontae Mays stopped by Travis Tuilomo. And we check in with Cassie Gallo. Cassie?
Well, Richie, right now, but the evidence is right here. It had been snowing all morning and afternoon in Logan. I talked to the stadium crew before the game. They said they had to get here at 7 in the morning to get the field ready. They plowed it three times, took off about 4 inches, a layer of snow. But ever since the game started, the sun came out, so we're in good shape there. It's not snowing anymore, but it is still very chilly. Now, a lot of times what you see and what BYU is using over on their sideline are these individual heaters that the players huddle around. But Utah State has the right idea. They've got this big machine here that's basically serving as an entire bench warmer. They cut holes in it. So it's basically an individual heater, personal heater for all the players. So, Rich, if you need me, I might be camping out over here.
Well, Cassie, you deserve it because this morning, and we'll have this later in the show, Cassie's big adventure this week, fly fishing. In about 20-degree weather in the snow this morning. So she deserves a little heat. Third down, 8. Keaton. And another drop. Devontae Robinson was open. He was headed to not only a first down, but much, much more than that.
Yeah, second drive in a row that we've had a key drop on a third down, and a good job by the offensive line picking up the blitz from Harvey Longy inside and giving Robinson time to cross the field. But I mean, that's something you got to have. That's right there in your hands. You see all the running room that he's going to have after the catch. And two drives in a row, Keaton's receivers letting him down on third down.
Now Utah State will take another crack at it. Third field goal attempt. Jake Thompson's had one blocked from this distance, and he hit an upright. It's a fake, and Utah State has that first down. Alex Huerta keeps the snap, gets the first down, 16 yards.
Now, I was kind of curious before the snap, Rich, that this was going to be another field goal attempt, considering what happened. But this is just option football, and he's reading the defender out there, Kai Nakua. He goes for the pitch, man, and that allows the running room to get up the field and make the play. What a great job by DJ Nelson, the backup quarterback there, holding the ball and picking up a big play.
And so on the fake, an injured Brigham Young player. 8:28 left. 0-for-2 on field goals. Why not a fake? And Utah State comes up with a big play. Thank you, Brent. A fake field goal has kept this Utah State drive alive.
And what is becoming a nice little rivalry here, Utah State and BYU. And that guy knows all about it, DJ Nelson. His older brother, Riley, played quarterback for a year here at Utah State and then transferred to BYU. DJ Nelson on that snap did a nice job on what looked like an option left. He kept it, and he gets a first down. The Tribe's still alive. Chucky Keaton in the shotgun. And Hunter Sharp gets the handoff. Sharp cuts back inside the 20, down to the 17-yard line. It's a gain of 3.
Hunter Sharp on the sweep. 2-yard gain. Tackled by Kai Nakua.
Kai Nakua made the stop for Brigham Young.
Good job of secondary support. Sai Tautu was the guy that had initial penetration. He couldn't quite make the tackle, but he made Sharp go more laterally, and that allowed that secondary to come up, recover, and make the play for only a 2-yard gain.
Second down and 8. Keaton, Sharp, first down to the sidelines, and he's out of bounds at the 6. Michael Wadsworth chases him out. 11 yards, Keaton to Hunter Sharp.
We've really seen a sharp game here for Keaton so far here today, especially in the 3-step passing game. And that was Sharp working against the best all-around defensive back here. Micah Hanneman broke him down, came inside, reverse field, and picked up another big game.
Those inside slants have been bread and butter for Chucky Keaton and Utah State. This time the handoff is to Hunt. The long Hunt. Got it! Touchdown! Muscles his way in. Utah State back on top.
Wow, what a run from LaJuan Hunt. And a good block by the left tackle, Ben Wysocki, filling in for Austin Albrecht. And you see Hunt right there just gets inside that pylon. But there was a collision in the backfield. And just a great job by Hunt recovering, bouncing to the outside, and getting a touchdown.
The fake field goal, the dash by DJ Nelson, kept the drive alive. Hunt, his 5th touchdown of the season. And Utah State, a gamble pays off. LaJuan Hunt, this the fake. DJ Nelson kept the drive alive. And then Hunt takes it in, and Utah State on top. It's a good sign for Brigham Young. Fred Warner went to the locker room. They find linebacker for BYU. Made the tackle, made the hit on that fake field goal. And he has come back onto the field. Utah State's drive. Remember, BYU, a pooch kick, a short kick, and that turned into a touchdown drive. LaJuan Hunt finished off the drive. And this has been an entertaining football game so far. In-state schools, the rivalry has really heated up over the last 5 years. Utah State has been able to get 2 wins in the last 5 games. Riley Burke breaks a tackle. Flags are down. Burke is finally down at the 40. There are 2 flags, one at the 38, one at the 27, and now another comes down at the 25. 39 yards on the return for Burke. There could be multiple fouls with the amount of flags that are down.
There are 2 fouls on the play by the receiving team. Holding number 3, us declined. Holding number 30, a penalty is accepted. 10 yards from the spot of the foul, first down.
This is going to back BYU all the way back to the 15-yard line. So costly penalties.
Mendenhall. BYU looking for win number 9.
Yeah, you see the hold came over to the left side of the screen.
That was quite a throw by the official. That flag went about 15, 20 yards. It's not easy. Mangum now in first and 10. Lots of time. Wanders right. Pumps, keeps, and slides. In front of Kyler Fackrell, who was closing in. Toyota, every week, has brought you going places. Who's going places? Well, Utah State at home has been tough to beat. Boise State, back in 2013, the last to win here. And of course, Utah State 2 years ago played in the Mountain West Championship game. Last year, they were 10-4. They come in at 6-5. Most feel better than their record. Mangum, hurry, and it's incomplete, and he took a hit back at the 3-yard line.
Well, the big thing they said that they wanted to do was make sure that they gave Mangum a lot of different looks and that they wouldn't give him a very clean place to throw from. Good job by Ricky Ali'ifua, the defensive tackle, of getting to Mangum and forcing him to throw that ball while he was off balance. But that was going to be the key, according to Kevin Kloon, their defensive coordinator, is giving him a lot of different things to look at and not allowing him to get comfortable here running the offense.
3rd and 7. Mangum has taken a lot of shots deep down the field, and he's hit on a couple. This is a short one. Matthews the catch. He stretches out, and he's short of the first down. That's been a fun matchup to watch. Mitch Matthews and DeShane Hines.
DeShane Hines gave up a pass early in the game, but since I think he's recovered quite nicely. And I think this is where Utah State defensively has a bit of an advantage. Down the field, this is a deadly wide receiving core, but they're not big separators. And I think the technical aspect and the athletic aspect of these corners, they have the advantage if they want to get in a quick passing game.
Johnny Linehan with a line drive punt, sharp back at his own 24. Connor Sharp back inside, still on his feet. Sharp is still going for the 42. That's a nice return. Great field position, 16 yards. For Hunter Sharp. Coming up, Verizon Halftime Report. Brett Stover, Houston Nutt, Christian Fourier. This is a rivalry day and certainly an enormous day for the college football playoff seedings. We'll get you up to speed on all the day's action. First half highlights and stats from this one. One of the highlights, certainly for Utah State, is that Chucky Keaton is healthy and on the field. In his long career, he's accomplished a lot of things, but he's never beaten Brigham Young. He's 0-3 against BYU. Keaton, of course, was injured last year. This is Robinson. In fact, last year, it wasn't Chucky Keaton. It wasn't Kent Myers. It was Daryl Garrettson who had a big day. Garrettson is no longer in the program here. He's transferred to Oregon State. But he threw for 321 yards.
You do know where Daryl Garrettson went to high school, right, Rich?
Oh, yeah. Go ahead, Arch.
That's the Chandler High School in Chandler, Arizona, that has turned into quite the powerhouse down there in the desert.
The mascot is?
That's the Wolf.
Thank you. On 2nd and 10, that one incomplete in a crowd, and it's incomplete. Now, last year, I think, was maybe a turning point in what is becoming a nice rivalry. You hate to see this. This was awful. Taysom Hill broke his leg. Now, BYU was 4-0 at this time. They were 18th in the country. And Daryl Garrettson went off.
Well, Rich, that could be very deflating for a football team to lose your quarterback when you're riding high and then he has to lead the game. I mean, that's a lot of adversity to try and overcome if you're BYU playing in that football game.
3rd down and 10. Keaton is flushed. Pumps, cuts. To midfield, got the first down. Keaton is loose to the 40, to the sideline. What a play by Chucky Keaton.
Boy, what a great job by Keaton, sensing the pressure coming off of his left side. First climbing inside the pocket, then breaking contain. Look at the open field moves right there, testing out that right knee, reversing field,
and picking up a first down. And that's really where you watched him last week in that big comeback against Nevada, was Keaton making some big plays on the ground in third down situations. And here he does it again.
It's a throw, and it's incomplete on a trick play. Keaton lined up as a wide receiver on a direct snap. Got it. Didn't like what he saw and just dumped it. Now the question would be, was it intentional grounding?
But just a really good job right here of the defensive backs responding to the reverse pass.
There is no foul for intentional grounding. Receiver was in the area.
That was Micah Hanneman back there, the cornerback, and Kai Nakua playing center field, recognizing that that was a trick play, staying back and nowhere for Utah State to throw the ball.
And the receiver that was there was the guy that took the direct snap, Nick Vigil. And it's the first time we've seen Vigil on offense, the linebacker for Utah State. A little more standard play call. This is Mays around the left side. He's upended after a nice pickup of 8 yards. And it will bring up third down and a short two for Utah State, up 14-10 over Brigham Young.
Well, you see the Aggies attacking the right side of that defense and breaking contain. Remember, Lawan Hunt scored the touchdown getting outside, and that time Sai Tautu, the outside linebacker, was a free hitter, and he failed to keep contain. And there you see that big speed that Devontae Mays brings to this offense.
Vigil in the backfield again, and he's going to keep it. Nick Vigil straight ahead. He's hit right at the first down stick at the 25. He had a dominant game against BYU last year on both sides of the ball, and he picks up the first down.
Four carries, 12 yards in his first action at running back last week. And boy, I tell you what, he looks like a linebacker right there. He was anxious, almost, he pretty much runs into Hunter Sharp coming across in motion, but aggressively goes inside and picks up the first down.
Now first and 10, Keaton in the shotgun. Mays to the corner, caught, it's safe. Chucky Keaton strikes again.
I think Hunter Sharp got away with just a little bit of a sharp to the back of Hanneman right there, but it was a great adjustment. Keaton, play action pass, throwing the ball downfield, and a great adjustment by the senior Hunter Sharp.
School record now for Chucky Keaton, 61 career touchdown passes. He is beloved by his teammate, by this school, by this community. And Utah State has ripped off a couple of scores and leads Brigham Young. Chucky Keaton getting the start. Kent Myers unable to play, and Keaton has been brilliant.
Well, just a really good job battling right here. Watch right at the end, Hunter Sharp, that right arm. It looked like it was a shove, but you know what? He really didn't give him much. It was more about that adjustment, tracking the ball. He never gave Hanneman any indication that that ball was coming. He adjusted just at the last second, and Utah State with a big play down the field for another touchdown.
Keaton had the 52-yard touchdown run to start the scoring, and he hooks up on a big play with Sharp. And just like that, Utah State, who has missed two field goals, has an 11-point lead, 21-10. I don't think he'll be smiling after that one. And now with 3 minutes left, Brigham Young's going to get the football back. BYU will have the football to start the second half. A line drive kick. Riley Burtz upended to the 28-yard line. It's getting that time of year again, the Nissan Heisman watch. Adam Archuleta, your thoughts?
Well, you know, you would have liked to end the season with a little bit more than 14 yards in your rivalry game. Deshaun Watson
I think he kind of took care of business against South Carolina, 393 total yards. And Christian McCaffrey continues. I mean, this guy might be a dark horse. I wouldn't be surprised, especially to see how he plays against Notre Dame in that last game of the season, to see him maybe continue to creep higher on that list.
Verizon Halftime Report is coming up. We'll get you up to speed on all of that. Mango, big shot caught by Matthews. Off to the races. Mitch Matthews, touchdown Cougars. 78 yards. Well, that's an answer. Maybe a smile out of Bronco Mendenhall after that one.
Boy, what a great job of responding and taking advantage of a missed assignment in the secondary to strike quickly.
Tanner Mangum has hit three deep balls, that one the deepest.
This is a four vertical route, and you see the corner right there. It looks like he's playing cover two, so that means that the safety, Marwin Evans, cannot allow himself to get influenced by that inside wide receiver. It was a great draw by Tanner Mangum, recognizing the flaw of the defense and getting it to Matthews, but you're going to see Marwin Evans peek inside and get influenced by that inside wide receiver, and then Mangum just lets it fly. Easy catch for Matthews, and the Cougars right back into it.
Wow. Mitch Matthews has had a terrific career and year. Remember, it started with that great catch on the Hail Mary in the first game at Nebraska. And that's the longest of his career.
Rich, two things that has to happen on that play. If it is, in fact, a cover two, that means that corner is playing short. But he's got to get his hands on that outside wide receiver. You've got to be able to slow down that one receiver to give your safety a little bit of relief. And if you're playing safety, you got to make sure you stay in your pedal. Don't allow any other receivers to influence you and break on that football. So two mental errors on that side of the secondary leads to a big play.
And the trend continues for Tanner Mangum. Deep balls to big receivers, and it has worked. Kennedy Williams for Utah State. Williams out to the 23-yard line. Now, if you're Chucky Keaton and you're Utah State, you've got a 21-17 lead. And he's been wonderful today.
He sure has, and he started off the game with that big 32-yard run, a 57-yard run on his own lead to get a touchdown. And he's been sharp. They turned to the quick passing game and moved the ball down the field. And then in their very last drive, throwing a strike down the field off of a play-action pass, beautifully executed to his favorite wide receiver, Hunter Sharp.
Are you cautious here?
No, absolutely not. Two minutes, 35 seconds on the 35-yard line. You got to go down and score. BYU gets the ball after half.
It's Hunt. And he's caught, and BYU is thinking that way. BYU's going to call a timeout after this first down carry goes nowhere.
Yeah, being conservative here. Now, you want to be judicious in how you throw the ball, because you don't want the Cougars, who have been really good at taking the ball away
timeout.
This season.
BYU, second charge timeout of the half.
To get an interception.
Please put 228.
Or a defensive touchdown. But I think you have to continue to be aggressive right here and try and get yourself some points going into halftime.
And, of course, this is a big play, ball-hawking BYU secondary. They have 15 interceptions this year. They have forced 20 turnovers.
Rich, one guy that I would maybe tend to stay away from is their free safety, Kai Nakua, who is maybe the very best of all ball-hawks. You're going to see 6 interceptions. That's 4th in the country this season. 2 picks last week, 3 against Boise State. But you got to be very careful. I think you continue to stay with that quick passing game and maybe take a couple shots down the field to Sharp if you get in good position.
Of course, the danger here, if you throw it and it's incomplete, Brigham Young doesn't have to use a timeout to stop the clock, although there is 2:28 left and get you down to about 2 minutes.
Yeah, I think you got to play for the first down. You know, I don't think you're at the point right now where you're you want to be mindful of the clock, but key here is to pick up a first down in this drive. You do not want BYU to get this ball before halftime.
So a second and 10. They'll keep it on the ground. Mays bounces out. Mays out to the 30. Michael Wadsworth made the stop. This is going to bring up third down and 4.
Great team defense for BYU, especially up front. The combination of Tui Loma and Taele, the two defensive tackles, stacking everything up inside, and then great support as Hunt tries to break outside to pick up yards.
Don't think you want Chucky Keaton blocking like he did on that last play.
No.
Especially if Kent Myers is not available. 6 of 9 on third down is Utah State. Keaton all alone in the backfield. Swings it out. It's Hunt, and he's smothered. And Brigham Young will burn a timeout. And BYU is going to get the football with plenty of time left in this first half.
It does not get any better, Rich, outside by Fred Warner, the outside linebacker who beats the freshman, Dax Raymond, gets off of the block as Lawan Hunt is trying to get outside and making a one-on-one tackle for no gain. I mean, that is excellent play outside by the sophomore linebacker.
And so a couple of timeouts. Brigham Young is out of timeouts. They called one early in the first half. But they're going to get the football with about a minute and a half left. Fred Warner was injured and went to the locker room early in this first half. Came back and makes a really nice play there. He's a sophomore who Bronco Mendenhall told us is getting better every game. Cassie Gallo, what's his status?
Yeah, Rich, a school official just said Fred Warner has a neck stinger. The doctors took a look at him. He wasn't in the locker room too long, about a couple minutes, but he ran back. He's cleared, good to go.
Cassie, how's the temperature down there right now?
The sun is covered up by clouds, but it's not too bad. It has gotten warmer throughout the day, but it's manageable, but still very chilly, Rich.
All right. Temperatures in the low 20s about an hour before kickoff. The snow stopped about half an hour before they kicked it off. Michael Shelton is deep. Not a good kick. Cutter was hit. It may have been partially blocked. There's no flag, and it looked like contact. But the ball wobbled before it landed. Let's take a look and see if someone got a hand on it.
A little bit of contact right at the end of the play.
Whoa. But no flag and no block. Grant Jones on the special teams. Now Brigham Young. Arch, what's been working?
Well, taking advantage of a leaky secondary there on that last play. I thought Utah State had done a great job up until that point. But you can see BYU still intent and attacking down the field.
Blitz comes, Mangum escapes, fires it, and on the sideline, it's incomplete. Nick Vigil on the coverage, and Marwin Evans on the blitz. Got some big targets out there for Brigham Young.
They sure do, and they all contribute. And almost in every single game, it's been somebody different. They have the advantage here. And they did a good job early in the game, but as of late, the defensive backs doing a good job of competing for the football.
Not a good throw. Mangum missed low. Devon Blackman was the intended receiver. And all of a sudden, it's third down and 10. And now Utah State may think about if they have some time left.
Yeah, absolutely. Two timeouts, a minute 15 left right here. And you maybe have to think about doing a run play and forcing Utah State to burn your timeout.
Mangum in the pocket. Oh, right on the money. Taron Houck, the intended receiver. Flag goes down, and it's in the defensive backfield all the way down at the 30-yard line.
Pass interference. Number 11 of the offense.
Wow.
15-yard penalty. He played third down.
Yeah, Rich, it was an easy call. He just...
And I think...
Correction. Our penalties decline. Fourth down.
Yeah, you're going to see Taron Houck right here, and he just throws the senior safety, Tyler Floyd, to the inside, and that's what allowed that separation. So that's a very good call that probably came from the back judge who was standing from behind and could easily see that play.
And Utah State declines the penalty, as you heard. Now, Utah State has got two timeouts. Johnny Linehan will punt it. That end-over-end punt. Oh, early contact. Flags fly. Andrew Rodriguez blowing up.
Rich, I thought he was blocked into him. And I think they're going to have to have a conference about this and maybe thinking about taking away that flag. But you're going to see, I can't get a number. He gets blocked into him right there.
Hunter Sharp was the blocker. Michael Davis on the coverage. And a big call in the balance as Bronco Mendenhall
looks off. Kick catch interference. Kicking team number 15. 15-yard penalty. First down.
I think that's kind of a tough call. You know, you can clearly see that Sharp, number four, to your left right there, hits him.
Was it enough of a hit, though, to propel him in?
I think it's a judgment call either way by the official standing on the field. I think that, you know, certainly Bronco Mendenhall has a case.
All right, now everything is flipped because it's Utah State with a minute two left and two timeouts.
And that was a big call because rather than being right around your 10-yard line and having to go 90 yards to try and get a touchdown, now you're in a pretty good spot to be aggressive and attack.
On the 31, quick snap, firing it out, and it's caught by Rodriguez. Clock will continue to roll. It's a gain of only three.
Really good tackle out there by Michael Davis, who came off the block. And if he didn't make that tackle, there's a good chance that Rodriguez would have had a chance to pick up some pretty good yardage.
Hunter Sharp at the bottom of your screen is the big play guy for Utah State. Keaton's going to fire a slant, and that one almost picked up. Micah Hanneman jumped the route and broke it up. It's third down and seven.
Well, you saw earlier in the game that Utah State was having a lot of success throwing slants on the inside, and that time Hanneman, instead of playing outside leverage before the snap, moved to the inside and didn't allow the receiver to get inside. Good job and a good adjustment by the cornerback.
Third down and seven. This is Mays, and he's got the first down. It's going to stop the clock while they move the chains. Utah State still has two timeouts. 29 seconds left. And the Aggies look to the sideline. They have to make sure they're ready to get this playoff. And they're wasting time right now. And they've just dropped 10 seconds from the clock. Keaton on a three-man rush. Time, and he fires it out. And for Utah State, that was almost a fatal stretch of time. Almost 20 seconds off the clock.
It's, you know, you would think with the clock stoppage on first down, you would have been able to gather yourself to snap the ball right as the official was signaling the ready for play signal. But way too much time going off the clock, especially when you consider the fact you're sitting here right about that 42-yard line. So now you maybe have two plays to get in the field goal position. You could have three or four plays if you would have got that snap off on time.
Second and 10, but just 12 seconds left. Hunt has checked in. Robinson and Sharp are your deep threats. Keaton escapes, pumps, fumbles. It's loose. Brandon Young has it. It's picked up. Rumbling with it. Tomasi Laulile. Touchdown, Brigham Young. Laulile, the sophomore, goes 42 yards.
I can't believe that this would happen. I mean, Chucky Keaton, who has played a great first half, has to understand the situation and can't put that ball in harm's way. He just flat drops it. And I don't know if that was just an unforced error trying to do so too much. Michael Shelton was the nickelback that was out there. But, boy, right before halftime, a disaster for Utah State.
The last play of the first half is a wild one and a big one. Tomasi Laulile, this is Keaton on the scramble.
Just a big-time mistake, trying to do too much, losing the ball. And how about Laulile coming up and rumbling for the touchdown? I mean, this is as bad as it could get for Utah State, but a great shot in the arm for BYU. Not only you score a touchdown before half, but now you get the ball in the first possession of the second half. What a major swing, major mistake by Keaton.
What a first half. Cassie Gallo is with Bronco Mendenhall. Cassie?
Well, Coach, you just get some momentum back. What did you see on that play?
Their quarterback's really elusive, and he was just trying to make a guy miss, and I think he just bobbled it himself, and we happened to have a guy close by. It's a wild game.
And what adjustments do you need to make for the second half?
Man, stop a fake field goal and quarterback scramble.
All right, thank you, Coach.
Thank you, Cassie. You saw the sign. Can Bronco smile? I think we saw a little smile there on a big play by Tomasi Laulile and the BYU defense. 24-21 at the half. BYU, we're headed to our CBS Sports Network studio in New York for the Verizon Halftime Report. You're watching college football right here on CBS Sports Network, the 24-hour home of CBS Sports.
Yeah, Rich, as far as that momentum swing, as BYU scored that touchdown after the fumble, I asked Coach Wells how we addressed it. He said, we didn't address it. And then I asked him about the missed kicks. He said, we didn't address those either. He said, all those things happened in the first half. We need to focus on what's going to win us the second half. And to do that, he said, Chucky Keaton needs to keep making big plays with his feet. So, Rich, he's not looking past. He's looking in the future and trying to get something going in the second half here.
All right, thank you, Cassie. And for Brigham Young, they get the football to start this second half. Snow and chilly in the morning. Some sunshine, but still cold temperatures in the first half. Cloud cover, second half. Riley Burt for BYU has a seam. And Burt spun around at the 35. That's a nice return out to the 38-yard line. How in the world do you contain Mitch Matthews?
Well, it's going to be tough. Because of his size and his exceptionally strong hands, it's a tough matchup down the field. And he's done what he's done all season. Big plays, right there exploiting a clock in the defense, racing to a 72-yard touchdown. I think defensively, they have to make sure they get hands on him. Don't allow him a free release. And you've got to be perfect when you play the pocket down the field. Not many defensive backs are going to outbattle Matthews for the football in a jump ball situation.
Brigham Young trying to get to 9-3 and polish that bowl resume. Algernon Brown left side. Brown's got a nice gain. He's inside Utah State territory, inside the 45 to the 42-yard line. And there's a little boost to the running game right off the bat.
Well, something they just didn't have in that first half. And they have to be able to get the running game going just a little bit. I think part of the problems offensively is the fact that if they weren't hitting big plays, they were not able to drive the ball down the field and get consistency offensively.
Just inside the 43, a 19-yard run by the junior, Algernon Brown. Mangum to throw. Flushed left. Keeps it and escapes. He will gain 4. Nick Vigil, Ricky Ali'ifua chased him out. Sonic, first half numbers for Tanner Mangum.
I think it was a little bit hot and cold for Mangum. And a big part of that, his wide receivers did a great job down the field battling for balls. And he did a good job of exploiting that mistake by the defense. But their short passing game, their intermediate passing game, hasn't shown a little timing or rhythm. Something that I think they're going to have to do in this second half to sustain something offensively.
Movement and flags up front. There were some key penalties in that first half. And a long discussion here.
Delay a game. Defense number 97. Simulating the snap. 5-yard penalty. Second down.
Uh-huh. Jordan Nielsen. Apparently simulating the snap. Kevin Kloon. He's had a really nice year in his first year as the defensive coordinator. Was coached here before, was the linebacker coach for 5 seasons. So the penalty makes it second down and 2. Mangum, another deep ball. Matthews, end zone. He got it! Touchdown! Mitch Matthews can't be stopped!
Touchdown to Mitch Matthews for BYU.
Unbelievable. Unbelievable. Mitch Matthews just takes this ball over the top of the 5'9" cornerback, Bryant Hayes, the backup corner on this defense. And unless there's an injury, I don't know why you don't put Jalen Davis, number 13, on Matthews. But that just was too easy. It looked like Matthews was playing against children out there, Rich. What a day for Matthews. His second long touchdown catch of the day. And BYU waiting to kick the extra point. You think about the last 2.5 minutes of the first half and the first minute and a half of this half. And Brigham Young has put 21 points on the board and absolutely changed the complexion of this football game.
Samson's good.
Mitch Matthews is 6'6", and he used every inch for that touchdown. Brigham Young with momentum. Matt Wells, the head coach at Utah State, has been in a long conference with the officials after that touchdown catch, the 35-yard throw from Tanner Mangum to Mitch Matthews. Matthews is getting some treatment on that right foot. 3 plays, 62 yards. And Matthews, a 35-yard catch. Matthews, 5 catches, 155 yards. 4th time he's had more than 1 touchdown in a game this season. We are told from the sideline that that discussion was about the illegal procedure called when Jordan Nielsen was called for simulating the snap count. That was before the touchdown throw. But right now, Utah State and their fans are in shock. Brigham Young has ripped off 21 consecutive in the span of about 4 minutes of game time.
Hey, look, here's the thing. You cannot self-destruct at this point. You have to be able to put that behind you and go out and play this second half like you started the first half if you're Utah State. Because this thing, Rich, this can escalate very quickly if they allow it to happen.
Sonic profile of Chucky Keaton in the first half. Now, remember, he had that awful fumble that turned into a touchdown on the last play of the half.
Yeah, that was a big play, and that contributed here to that the snowball here for BYU gaining some momentum. But outside of that play, I thought Keaton was brilliant. I thought he did a great job in the design quarterback runs, making stuff happen when the passing game broke down, and he was very sharp, distributing the ball very nicely and accurately to his wide receivers.
On 1st and 10, on the ground, Devontae Mays and Brigham Young. Remember the whole sequence of events. It was a stop by Brigham Young that got the football back with a little over 2.5 minutes left in that first half. So the defense has helped fuel this run.
And they're continuing to get great play from their defensive tackles up front. They have completely dominated Utah State's offensive line at the line of scrimmage.
Bronson Kafusi, Logan Taele. And, of course, in the middle, you got Travis Tuiloma. Flag goes down after a two-yard pickup. Michael Wadsworth in on that hit. He's in on a lot of hits. He's their leading tackler.
Holding. Number 76 offense. 10-yard penalty. We play second down.
And the news gets worse for Utah State. Jake Simonich, the junior tackle.
Yeah, you know, I think they called Simonich, I think, on the linebacker, Harvey Longy. And I got to tell you, from my vantage point, it looked like a pretty ticky-tack call.
Second and 20. Keaton will keep. And a nice job by Brigham Young. Another flag goes down. Sharp and Michael Davis were locked up just as Keaton slid down. And there's a look at Davis.
There is no foul for holding. Third down.
Rocco Mendenhall wants to know, why was the flag thrown?
Yeah, they're looking right. You're going to watch the left side of your screen right there. That was a playing question, and I'm really, really glad that I saw them pick up that flag, because they got to let these guys play a little bit more out there.
This is an enormous third down and 18. A shotgun. Keaton. Over the middle and incomplete.
Keaton's pass incomplete.
Dax Raymond, the freshman out of Provo, the intended receiver. And the BYU defense gets the football back for a red-hot offense.
Yeah, very lethargic start here for Utah State coming out after halftime. You hope there's not residual effect from the disaster in the first half, but not a lot of energy offensively. I didn't really agree with running it twice in a row there against BYU's defense. And now you're fourth and 18, giving it back to a red-hot offense.
Michael Shelton with a fair catch called for and made. Every week, it's another adventure for our Cassie Gallo. This morning, temperatures in the teens. No problem, a little fly fishing. Logan, Utah, Brigham Young on a roll and up by 10. Now, all year, she has done some amazing things, from swimming with sharks, skydiving, barrel racing. Cassie Gallo, this morning, I can't believe you got up and got in that water and went fly fishing this morning.
Yeah, Rich, sun, rain, or snow, our adventures live on here in Logan, Utah. And today we went fly fishing, and our guide was Justin from Utah Pro Fly Fishing. He took us out to Logan River, which is right behind the stadium. I caught two good-sized fish. I was actually two for two. One was a rainbow trout, the other a brown trout. And since it's catch and release, we sent them back on their way. But even though it was snowing, we had a great time. Fly fishing in the snow was my first, but the snow doesn't affect the fish, only humans, Rich.
I like the fact that you kissed the fish. That's very nice, a nice touch. I mean, it was in the teens this morning when Cassie was up. That ball's on the turf, and it bounces back to Mangum, and almost a disaster for Brigham Young. He's going to end up losing about 10 yards.
This time, Mangum under center going with the lead draw, and that was read perfectly by the senior linebacker, LT Filionga, who was originally a Utah Ute, but he blitzed inside, puts a great shot on Brown, and Mangum very fortunate to get that ball back. That's what they need defensively, somebody to make a spark and get some life back into this football team.
Second and 20, blitz comes, Mangum with time, and he fires that one high. He was looking for Kurt Henderson, who had a big catch earlier in the first half. As Adam pointed out, you can go up and down the squadron of wide receivers. And for Bronco Mendenhall, Mitch Matthews, Taron Houck, Devin Blackman, Henderson, Juergens, all of them have had significant catches throughout this season, which has led Brigham Young to an 8-3 mark, looking for 9-3. On third and 20, another blitz comes. Mangum flushed, throws, and it's incomplete. It just got past the line of scrimmage. He had pressure. Bryant Hayes. And a flag does go down. And it looks like grounded.
Yeah, I was just going to say that the offensive line has done a really good job on Fackrell and the rest of that defense. And just as I think that.
Intentional grounding. Number 12 of the offense. Crossing down, spotted the foul. Fourth down.
Rich, just as I say that, Bryant Hayes, the nickel cornerback, with a very well-timed blitz coming up inside and getting to Mangum and forcing a big mistake. Now, the Utah State offense should at least enjoy very good field position, and that's the kind of play that they desperately needed to get some life back in their team.
Even though he was 20 yards behind the line of scrimmage, Mangum was still within the tackle box. And so fourth and 36. It's a Johnny Linehan punt and an end-over-end special caught at the 48-yard line on a fair catch. Temperatures in the teens when Cassie Gallo was in the river. Mid-20s right now and dropping 31-21 BYU.
College football on CBS Sports Network is being brought to you by Chick-fil-A. We didn't invent the chicken, just the chicken sandwich. By LG. Do game day right with LG, official partner of the NCAA. By Sonic's new ultimate chicken sandwich. And by national mortgage lender Quicken Loans. Home buy, refi, power.
In Logan, Utah, Utah State finds themselves down 10 to Brigham Young, but with great field position at the BYU 47. Chucky Keaton has run the team all day. Keaton will keep and now pitch. It's Mays, and he's got a nice pickup of 11 yards. Harvey Longy made the stop for Brigham Young. Last possession was not a good one for Utah State. Adam Archuleta, what are you looking for on this one?
Well, the last two possessions have been terrible for Utah State. They've got to get back into it. I thought that early in the game they did a really good job in their quick passing game, moving the ball down the field. Now, they had a couple of missed field goals, but they were very efficient offensively. So I expect Keaton to go back to that three-step passing game to get some rhythm.
From the 36, Keaton, a quick throw. It's a dart, and it's incomplete. It was just behind Devontae Robinson, who A, couldn't hold it, and then B, paid the price.
Well, the second drop of the day for Robinson, and this is something that you got to have. This is off coverage against Henneman, and there was plenty of separation right there. Yes, that ball was behind you, but I've seen Robinson make that catch all season long. That's one that, boy, when you're trying to get something going on offense, few times here today, the wide receiver is dropping some passes.
Second down and 10. Mays. Brunson Kafusi, the senior, on the stop. Kafusi has been around the ball all day long. He's had a terrific season, an All-American type season.
Well, you don't see this too often, getting around the block and then pass or down the line of scrimmage. Look at the quick hands. And then the speed to track it down from the other side. You know, that's that kind of stuff right there, playing the run, is what the NFL is looking for.
Third down, 8 for Utah State. Keaton again, and this one, Robinson, the intended receiver. And it almost looked like he didn't see the ball coming.
It was kind of a strange passing concept, because the underneath wide receiver Braylon Roberts was kind of in that passing window, and the guy that was defending him was Hanneman in the corner, and Hanneman was in that throwing window, and that's why Keaton had to throw the ball where he did.
Aaron Dalton, a rare punt for Utah State. They haven't had many at all. That's a interesting catch there, a dangerous one. Michael Shelton makes it. And so BYU is going to be backed up for this possession. LG presents Duke Game Day Right. It's game day today, but you know what, Arch? Recruits on campus tomorrow. They check in at 11:30. They see the big video clip. Wouldn't it be nice to roll in highlights of a win? Coach Wells welcomed them. Actually, this is today's schedule, and they are here to watch this game, take the field, enter the stands, and watch what is turning into a really nice rivalry with Utah State and BYU.
A lot of these recruits may be deciding on whether or not BYU or Utah State is the place to be. And for Utah State, which is considered a smaller school, would be a big feather in their cap if they could find a way to get back in this game and come out of here with a win.
Well, they won last year handily in Provo. But Brigham Young with 21 unanswered points has a 10-point lead here. 9:49 left in the third. Brown in the backfield. Algernon Brown gets it, trying to kick it outside, and he'll gain maybe two.
Tackled by Nick Vigil.
Nick Vigil on the stop. Kyler Fackrell was there as well.
And one guy, we touched on him a little bit earlier in the game, Rich, but David Mawala, number 51, the nose tackle. A lot like Tui Loma on the other side of the ball, has been the key to this defensive line, and he just dominated the center inside, stacked everything up, and good support around him.
Shotgun for Mangum. And a quick throw on the money. Colby Pearson, the catch. He's going to be short of the first down. Jalen Davis and Marwin Evans with the stop. Third down and about a yard for Brigham Young. A lot of BYU fans in the house. A sellout here, and the snow is starting to fall again. Quick throw, Mangum. And, of course, he goes to the big man, Mitch Matthews, who hauls it in. It's only a 3-yard gain, but it's a first down.
I was a little surprised that they didn't go heavy formation right there and run Algy Brown behind his right guard and his center. But a good job, again, of Mangum finding the matchup, going to his money wide receiver and picking up that first down.
Matthews, 6 catches, 158 yards, 2 long touchdowns. Algernon Brown. Utah State's run defense has been excellent today. Nick Vigil made the stop.
They really have. And that's just a great example right there of playing your leverage and doing your job. The right side of the defensive line holding their gap. There was nowhere for the running back to run the football, and then when you have an athletic linebacker with the speed of Vigil, he's just going to walk it down. That was just great team defense and everybody staying in their gap.
Just 24 yards today, 2nd and 9. Francis Bernard in the backfield with Mangum. Shoots it over the middle. Caught there at the 26-yard line, and that's Remington Peck, who started the year as a defensive lineman, came over midseason. As a tight end, he threw for a touchdown last week. His 6th catch as a tight end, and he's a big one, 6'4", 275.
And it's got to be refreshing for Bronco Mendenhall to see that they have gone to their short passing game. And his quarterback has done a good job. He's made good decisions. He's been accurate. More importantly, his wide receivers have caught the ball for him here on this drive.
3 of 7 on third downs. 3rd and 2 here. Again to the air. Mangum flushed, tripped up and stopped. Back at the 22-yard line. David Mawala, the transfer from Arizona State.
Well, here he is, number 51, initially a quick little double team. And then just continuing to work. And that's against the right tackle, Lapuaho. And again, David Mawala. Both of these nose guards here today, not really known for their pass rush abilities, but making plays both in the running game and the passing game, they've been outstanding.
Travis Tui Loma for BYU, and of course David Mawala for Utah State. Hunter Sharp, and Sharp breaks loose. Sharp is down to the 32-yard line, and Utah State again has great field position. 6 minutes left, 3rd quarter. This is a nice rivalry. 10-point BYU lead. Senior day here. What a great senior class this has been. They are one win from equaling the record for wins of a senior class, which was set last year. But you can't have a senior day without a wedding proposal. To Ani Fisilao. And we're happy to report she said yes.
Very classy move.
Now on the field, as Fisilao watches, Utah State again with great field position. This time the BYU 31. They came away with no points on their last drive, which started in BYU territory. Keaton on play action. Trying to scramble, fires it away, and that might be grounding. Right now the officials conferring. Keaton trying to just get rid of the football. Boy, that's going to be really close. Boy, Bronson Kafusi.
Intentional grounding. Number 16 in the offense. Ball did not reach the line of scrimmage. Lost it down. Second down.
Now outside the tackle box, which he was, if you don't get it past the line of scrimmage and there's nobody around, that's grounding.
Well, Kafusi here in the last two series has really shown what kind of devastation he could wreak on the offensive line. They kept two players over on that right side, and they just couldn't contain the combination of Kafusi and Warner, and they forced a big mistake on Keaton.
Keaton to the air. Oh, terrific catch. Sharp. Not a first down, but it will bring up a manageable third down. In traffic, Sharp selling out. Ball at the 25. It's third down and four.
A really nice touch on that ball. He has to get it over the linebacker, Sai Tautu, number 31. And then I just love that extension by Sharp to snatch that ball out of the hand and make a catch for his quarterback.
So third down and four. Remember, Utah State has missed two field goals today, both of those early in the first half. Keaton, lots of time. Now the pocket collapses. Keaton trying to get the first down, and he does. Little stutter step there, Adam Archuleta, and then he put it in gear.
He's really good at it, and what they were trying to do was run crossing routes and try and kind of set a natural pick, but BYU did just a great job over there of taking that away. He got a good block by Jake Simonich on Kafusi, which allowed him to get to the edge in the first place. And then special quarterbacks with special movement skills have this type of ability to pick up first downs while running the football.
Devontae Mays behind him, first and 10 at the BYU 18. This is Mays, breaks a couple tackles, but couldn't get out of the clutches of Sai Tautu. Horizon red zone. Utah State has arrived in it. They've been in there twice. They have a touchdown.
Those two field goals, missed field goal, the one block and the one missed field goal could come in very handy right now, Rich. But one thing that they haven't done a good job of today in this game is first down running success. I think you have to start thinking about passing the ball a little bit more on first down.
Second and eight. They'll run it here with Mays. And again, there's nothing going, and he runs right into Travis Tuiloma and Harvey Longhi.
Good job of Tuiloma up front, again, playing the block of the center. But then you see the speed of the former running back, Harvey Longhi, racing off of that right edge and chasing it down from the backside. So Bronco Mendenhall blitzing a little bit more in this game, something that, you know, he doesn't like to do too much. He thinks that they could play more base defense. Right now, bringing some heat and getting to this offense.
Brigham Young's going to call a timeout.
Timeout.
Bronco Mendenhall will have a chance to set his defense on what is a rather important third down and eight. Deep in BYU territory, Utah State.
30-second timeout.
Had a 21-10 lead, but Brigham Young with 21 unanswered, including a wild play at the end of the first half. And a score. Another big play for their big receiver, Mitch Matthews, to start this second half. Don't miss In the Heart of the Sea from Academy Award-winning director Ron Howard, which is in theaters on December 11th. Remember how this offense was purring early in the first half, Adam Archuleta?
I do. And, you know, they kind of hit a big stumbling block right before halftime. Was the big one, but they haven't been able to get consistency. Look, three plays, five plays, four plays, and four plays with zero time of possession. That means their defense has been on the field quite a bit. And, you know, look, Brigham Young, their defense this year in the red zone only allowing 57% touchdown percentage. That's one of the best red zone defenses in the country. They've shown just how good they can be here in this game.
Third down, eight. Keaton in trouble, and he wings it up into the seats.
Ball made the line of scrimmage. Quarterback was out of the pocket.
And so it looks like Matt Wells is going to try for three. Thompson has had one partially blocked, had another hit the upright. And, of course, on another attempt, they had that great scamper by DJ Nelson.
Not a great situation to be in, because I'm sure that Matt Wells does not have a lot of confidence right now in his field goal kicking. And you figure you get 3 points, that puts you 8 points down, just a touchdown and a two-point conversion away. But, you know, the way they've been running their offense, converting on a fourth and eight really doesn't give you a lot of options either. So not a very great situation for Matt Wells to be in.
33 yards, Nelson the hold, and again it's blocked, and it's picked up. Brigham Young has got it. Hanneman up the sideline. Hanneman stays in bounds to the 20. Hanneman to the 15, and he's down to the 10. Micah Hanneman, after another blocked field goal attempt. Big play after big play for Brigham Young today.
It was hard to see. It was either Tui Loma, Kafusi, or Fred Warner who got their hands on that ball. And I believe it was Bronson Kafusi with his second field goal block of the day, getting his arms up that 6-8 frame, a very low trajectory kick right there. And then Hanneman on the spot to pick it up, and just major swings in this football game here today. And special teams field goal unit for Matt Wells is killing this football team.
And now Tanner Mangum and the BYU offense on the field and looking for 6 points. Francis Bernard to the end zone. Touchdown BYU.
10-yard run, Francis Bernard for BYU at the touchdown.
Unbelievable turn of events. And BYU capitalizing. It's been a big play day for the Cougars, and a big reason why they were rolling. Great job of sealing off that left side, and the freshman easily walks in for the touchdown.
Let's go!
That's 28 unanswered points from the 2.5 minute mark going into halftime. And now with 3 minutes left in the third, 28 straight points. And almost all of those points have a big play attached to them.
Yeah, absolutely. It's been all big plays. And, you know, look, that's part of it. That's part of winning games, big games, is winning that big play department. And all the critical situations here today, BYU has been on the plus side of that. And you see what kind of an impact it has on this game. But boy, Utah State has to be extremely deflated right now. I was concerned about them going into halftime. But the way this third quarter has started, man, it doesn't look like anything can stop the Cougars.
Special teams have been very special for Brigham Young. This is Kafusi, the first field goal that he blocked. This is the second attempt by Thompson. And as you pointed out, I don't know if that kick was going anywhere with any success. It was a low-line drive. Regardless, a great return by Hanneman.
Yeah, but, you know, if he misses it low and left, at least you're going to make BYU, you know, drive, you know, 70 yards to try and get a touchdown. But an excellent special teams play by the senior captain, Kafusi, again. And giving Hanneman a chance to flip the field position, and the ensuing walk-in touchdown follows.
8 block kicks, the leader in FBS. To the 14. And now the field position isn't so good for Utah State. Thursday night football, Aaron Rodgers and the Packers. And the Lions, Calvin Johnson. It's Thursday night football on Thursday, back on CBS and NFL Network. Well, you may see some Brigham Young Cougars on that Detroit Lions team. There's a couple of really good defensive linemen, defenders that have entered the NFL. Kyle Van Noy, Ziggy Ansah.
This game, suddenly in the last 2 weeks, is getting a lot more interesting than it could have been, because Detroit is playing really well right now, and you've got to kind of wonder where the confidence is for Aaron Rodgers and the Green Bay Packers.
Oh, another terrific catch there. Rodriguez has it, races across midfield, still on his feet, hauled down at the 27-yard line. Andrew Rodriguez, the junior, that was not an easy catch. And he races for a big gain.
Well, assignment breakdown in the secondary, and that's just easy. Keaton wisely sees that Rodriguez is wide open. There's nobody. He's not even touched until he's 30 yards down the field.
That's 58 yards on the completion from Chucky Keaton. First and 10. Keaton pulls it on play action. And he fires it away from Harm's reach.
Keaton and Kafusi,
who have seen, I'm sure, a lot of each other, more than Keaton would like, not only today, but in their careers at BYU and at Utah State.
Well, I think, you know, you go back to that last play, and we talked about, maybe get away from that first down running, you know, get to some first down passing, and you saw a good job right there of Keaton recognizing what the defense is giving him and capitalizing. But I think as this game goes on, I don't know if you want to abandon the running game, but I don't know if it's going to be a big part of your offense.
Mays straight ahead on second and 10, and this is going to bring up a long third down. Third down and 8 or 9.
Austin Heater for BYU.
Very longy. Made the stop.
It's just once Utah State gets in this part of the football field, it's been a version of the Iron Curtain. BYU's defense has been impenetrable down here. And Utah State's going to have to find a way to solve that riddle.
Little screen, an inside screen. Rodriguez is caught from behind after he gains 4 yards. And I don't think there's any question you're going to go for it on fourth down. You're 0-3 with 2 blocks in field goal attempts.
Yeah, you got to start getting points on the board. You're down by 17 points. And the way your field goal unit has been operating, 4th and 5 right here, you got to make it happen.
Receiver stacked on the right and the left. Blitz comes. Keaton's throw in traffic. It's caught. A thunderous hit. And Braylon Roberts held on. That is impressive. First down, Utah State.
Well, Harvey Longy almost gets to Keaton. But this is just a great job of concentration. He takes a shot from the free safety, Nakua. And in a critical down where you have to have it for you to have a chance to be in this football game, boy, oh boy, Roberts comes down with a grab.
9 yards on the pickup. Ball at the BYU 14. Keaton in the shotgun. Hands it off to Hunter. Sharp around the end. He scampers. And he will pick up a couple of yards. Harvey Longy was there for another stop. And Utah State, their offense really clicked almost the entire first half, but the last 2.5 minutes of that first half, disastrous for the Aggies. Great plays, big ones by both the offense and the defense of BYU. And again, it's BYU with the 2 touchdowns here in the second half. Keaton now on second and eight. They stay on the ground. Mays. And that BYU front seven is really tightened up. Yardage on the ground, tough to come by for Utah State. Temperatures drop. Brigham Young rises 38-21, headed to the fourth. Avalanche of big plays by Brigham Young has erased a 21-10 Utah State lead. And you can see the run. The last 28 have been all Brigham Young. Rich Waltz, Adam Archuleta, Cassie Gallo here in Logan as the temperatures drop into the lower 20s. Third down and 10. Utah State at the Brigham Young 14. Chucky Keaton has found success over the middle in the last two possessions for the Aggies. Keaton, corner blitz, gets it off. End zone, and it's incomplete. Contact and a flag. Dax Raymond in the pattern. Flag came from the far corner of the end zone.
Yeah, I think it's a good call. Harvey Longy came out, and he's got his back completely to the football and makes contact before Raymond can catch the ball. So that is a, boy, that is a huge play, giving Utah State a first down on third and 10 and giving them a little bit of life.
Pass interference. Defense. Ball replaced on the 2-yard line. Automatic first down.
And they put it at the 2.
The foul was on number 21 of the defense.
And of course, Longy, the guilty party. Nick Vigil is the guy they look to in short yardage, the outstanding linebacker for Utah State. And Vigil, who scored a touchdown against BYU last year, is in there right now. And a direct snap. Vigil straight ahead. The big man spins, and he's in. Second carry for Vigil. The first was for a key first down. This for a touchdown.
It's what he does really well. A former high school running back, hasn't played much running back this season, mostly in those short yardage situations, but following his left guard Tyshawn Mosley into the end zone and gives Utah State a much needed touchdown, Rich, to at least give themselves a chance. Now their defense has to do a great job on this ensuing drive to give the ball back to their offense.
Well, the extra point is good. And so that 28-point run by BYU is over. Nick Vigil takes it in. Utah State trying to climb back in the cold, in Logan. Nick Vigil is in. Well, it wouldn't be BYU against Utah State if Nick Vigil didn't touch the ball on offense. He has had two carries. This touchdown is fourth of his career, as you noted, a standout running back in high school. And out of the direct snap. That time he showed a little more patience, though, Archie. He waited for his blockers a little bit longer.
Not much. I think it was just that Sharp was a little faster getting across the formation.
Riley Burt from his 3. He's come close to breaking a couple, but not this one. Good special teams. Flags fly at the 20-yard line, pushing and shoving. And I guess it's all part of an in-state rivalry, which is growing a lot more heated ever since Utah State's program was on the rise. They've been able to beat Brigham Young two of the last five meetings.
Holding. Number 41 in the return team. 10-yard penalty. First down.
And that's not a penalty that's going to make Bronco Mendenhall real happy. This, Arch, you feel a very key drive.
I do. I think it is. You know, BYU right now, they have to take this ball and either run time off the clock, flip the field position, or get a touchdown. You cannot go a three and out, get a quick possession, and allow Utah State to get this ball with great field position.
Mangum short on the throw to Taron Houck. And it's second down and 10. The amazing thing about Tanner Mangum, he's had an outstanding year. He was not at spring ball. He was returning from his LDS mission in June from Chile. And so fall practice, and that's it. And that LDS mission is 2 years, and there is very little football involved. Maybe once a month you can throw the ball around.
Now just think how good he can be when he has a full spring, a full summer, and a full fall camp. He's going to be outstanding quarterback.
Mangum rolling to his left. Fires it incomplete. We go down to the sideline, Cassie Geller.
Rich, this stadium is electric right now. The fans are very much in this game. So are the players. They're up on their feet. Head coach Matt Wells has been getting in all the guys' faces, telling them, let's go, we can do this. But the fans are loud, and they are trying to get this team to stay in this, guys.
And Cassie, they were gone for, a 28-point stretch there.
Yeah, exactly, but they are loud. You can barely hear what's going on because they are in this game right now.
Well, you got to find a way, Rich, to put heat on the quarterback. Kyler Fackrell has got to be able to show up in a big way right here.
Utah State shows blitz. Here they come. Mangum with time. Deep ball. Blackman in a crowd. Has it. Another jump ball won by a BYU receiver. And it's Blackman who comes down with it.
It's really incredible. You know, Blackman is the fastest of the wide receivers. He's 6 foot tall, so he doesn't have the wingspan of a Matthews. But in double coverage right there, between Hayes and Floyd, goes up, gets the football, and comes down with a major play for his offense. Unreal how well these wide receivers compete for the football.
35 yards. Mangum again. Short ball this time. And it's incomplete. And it was Blackman who was the intended receiver.
Well, and look, you know, we didn't get a chance to see it, but Mangum was under intense pressure. He got hit pretty hard because Utah State Kevin Kuhn brought the blitz, but he hung inside the pocket, threw that ball up, and his senior wide receiver goes up and gets it.
Five big balls today. Five passes over 35 yards for Tanner Mangum. Second and 10. Brown in the backfield. Blitz comes. Brown scoops right through. Has a nice pickup inside the 35 to the 33-yard line. Algernon Brown, leading rusher for BYU. Tyler Floyd with the tackle.
Yeah, blitz off the left side, and the linebacker right here, Filiunga, he's got to close this space. He doesn't collapse down far enough, and that allows that big space for Brown to hit that cutback. If you blitz a player off of that left side, somebody has got to be able to close that gap and get to the running back and not allow that big cutback.
Just about in field goal range. Another 4 or 5 yards should do it. To the 22-yard line. And hey, how about that? If one linebacker can run it, how about Harvey Longy coming in and running the football?
Yeah, showing those former instincts. We mentioned that he used to play running back here at BYU, and he sees that there is nobody on the edge of that defense to force him back in, and he easily hits it and picks up a big first down.
So, Nick Vigil, anything you can do, I can do better. And Longy is in there right now. First and 10, Utah State 22. Why not let the big man have it again? And I guess for nice symmetry, Vigil tackles Longy on that carry.
Well, Mangum in the offense, they really did what they had to do in their first priority. That was to get out from their own, deep in their own territory, and establish this drive and flip the field position. Right now is when you can start chewing up that clock.
One linebacker to the other. Both have carried the football twice. Second and seven. Mangum hit as he throws. End zone. Incomplete. Flags are down. Nick Kurtz, another big receiver at 6'6". Flag is at the two. There was contact. And let's see.
You know, I don't think there was that much contact.
Pass interference. Number 17 of the defense. 15-yard penalty. Automatic first down.
You know, I don't think there was that much contact, to tell you the truth. There was a lot of hand fighting going on between Hines. And I just, I got to tell you, I just thought that was a very ticky-tacky call. I thought Nick Kurtz did a good job trying to make that adjustment.
A little jersey grab there.
Small little grab right there, but I mean, I don't know. I think that's, what would the kids say, Rich? That's weak sauce.
Swing pass, Bernard. Dives in. Touchdown, Brigham Young. Second touchdown for Francis Bernard. And BYU has an answer.
Well, they don't only go up and get balls, but the wide receivers blocking on the edge and giving Bernard that extra space. But you can't say enough on how the Cougars responded offensively to start their drive. Third and 10, and you go up, you beat double coverage for a big jump ball, you make plays down the field, you put in your linebacker at running back to pick up first downs, and then you punch it in and cap it off with a touchdown. That was a brilliant drive by Mangum and the Cougar offense.
Extra point. He hooked it and missed it. And the ball's picked up. That could be returned. Wait a minute. Whistles now behind the play. DeShane Hines is into the end zone.
The ball hit the goal post.
And that means it's dead.
5-point, no good.
But it took the officials about 40 yards to realize that. Hines was well on his way.
It would have been fun, though. That would have been awesome. Yeah, but I believe once the ball, you know, crosses the end zone, you cannot run it back.
See, the officials still hadn't blown the whistle. Brigham Young, a big score. They're up 44-28. Chick-fil-A brings you the fan cam, and I must say the football fans in the state of Utah may be the heartiest fans in the country because they didn't blink. Temperatures in the teens leading up to kickoff had crept up to the mid-20s, dropping down into the lower 20s right now here in Logan, Utah, where Brigham Young has scored again. Still, Utah State has shown some big playability. That's a 90-yard drive. Bernard with his second touchdown. And 12 minutes left, Adam Archuleta, so there is time. Kennedy Williams. Nice tackle. Lost a shoe. Then Utah State gets the football. Tonight, 9 Eastern, Colorado State heads to Bulldog Stadium to take on Fresno State. Mountain West Showdown presented by Geico. It's right here on the 24-hour home of CBS Sports. Bowl games and all of that, certainly the pecking order in the Mountain West on the line today. Rashad Higgins, the fine receiver for Colorado State, trying to add to what has been a great career. And now Utah State on the ground. A wrestling match. I did not see a flag, though. Luan Hunt went out with some help at the 35-yard line. No Of course, Utah State is bowl eligible at 6-5. Brigham Young is as well. And they're trying to get to 9-3. This is Hunt. And a couple of big runs. That on second and one. That's a 10-yard pickup. And a first down for Utah State.
They got to start up ramping it up a little bit. Tempo has to be more of a factor. And, you know, they're coming up, taking their time. You've got to score 16 points, two touchdowns and two two-point conversions, and stop BYU. Got to be able to snap the ball very quickly as you try and get down the field.
Play action, Chucky Keaton with time. And that one over the hand of his intended receiver. Braylon Roberts in the pattern, second down and 10. For Keaton, it's been an interesting day. Not sure if he was going to start. Kent Myers, we were told a game time decision, his shoulder not sound enough to go. So Keaton, who's had such a long career with great numbers and, of course, great disappointments with all the knee injuries, gets a start. He gets his final crack at Brigham Young. Blitz from the side, and he had to unload it faster than he wanted.
Keaton's pass is incomplete.
Yeah, look at this. This is two plays ago, and it looked like that ball just, it looked kind of strange when it happened there in real time. It looked like it kind of just got away from his grip and floated through the air there. But the timing that we saw in that first half from Keaton and his wide receivers in this passing game, quite simply, hasn't been there this fast. You have to really credit the job that this defense, after getting outplayed in the first half, how they've come out here in the third and fourth quarter.
Third down, 10. Keaton flushed. Has to throw it, and he throws it away. And Brigham Young's defense holds.
Ball made line of scrimmage. Quarterback was out of the pocket.
Kent Myers, the sophomore, who has a very promising future, you would expect here in Logan. Think about the three quarterbacks they've had in their program the last couple of years. Keaton, Myers, and Daryl Gerritsen, who transferred to Oregon State.
Well, remember last year, Myers got his shot, and he was the fourth-team quarterback there at the end of the season. And he did a great job and had a winning record as a starter. So you got to credit Matt Wells and his staff on how they've been able to develop quarterbacks here for the Aggies.
Brigham Young trying to run clock to get themselves a road win. It's 44-28. For those of you concerned they got the logo upside down on this field, this is a year of construction here in Logan. You can see from the far side, a giant press box and luxury suite facility is under construction. So a temporary press box, that means everyone is on the opposite side of the field. Our cameras, all of the press, and the construction rises in Logan. Scheduled to be completed for opening kick of next fall. There we are. Art, this is our little slice of heaven right up here.
It is. It's very heavenly.
Yeah, then the heater works, which is good. Now Brigham Young trying to move the football, run the clock. Francis Bernard bounces out of bounds. And we go down to Cassie Gallo. Cassie?
Yeah, Rich, you mentioned the construction, and some exciting changes are happening around Utah State. They're adding on some big renovations, like you said, which is part of a $36 million stadium project. Yesterday, we got to take a look around. They're putting in 24 luxury suites and more than 700 club seats. And the university is excited about it because it upgrades the whole game day experience, and everything should be done for next season.
Very nice. That'll help them attract some bigger name opponents in non-conference. They have this home and home with Brigham Young for a few more years. BYU going nowhere fast here. It's third down and three. Algernon Brown, the carry.
Tackle by number 24, Marwin Evans for the Aggies.
Tanner Mangum in his first year. Of course, another injury for Taysom Hill that happened early in the very first game on the road against Nebraska. Mangum came in. Through that Hail Mary touchdown to Mitch Matthews. It's been a pretty nice ride for the 22-year-old out of Eagle, Idaho since. Bernard, and he's short of the first down to the 19-yard line. And so Utah State's going to get the football back with 9 minutes left.
Yeah, it's a great job here for Utah State getting off the field. But they haven't been able to establish anything positive for a sustained amount of time here in that second half. And so, you know, you saw a couple of ugly drives from the offense. They got to find a way here in this next drive to try and put points on the board. They have to do it quickly because they're running out of time.
Johnny Linehan to punt it for BYU, a low liner. A nifty catch by Rodriguez. He swallowed up right at midfield and falls into BYU territory at the 49. Utah State down two scores. Gets it when we return.
College football on CBS Sports Network is being brought to you by Bud Light, the perfect beer for whatever happens. By Enterprise Rent-A-Car. Pick Enterprise. We'll pick you up. By Sonic's new Ultimate Chicken Sandwich. And by Toyota. Let's go places.
9 minutes left in Logan. Brigham Young, a 44-28 lead. Utah State with the football. Blitz comes, and it comes early. And there's movement on both sides. Harvey Longy came across. Was he drawn off?
False start. Number 76 of the offense. 5 yard. Please reset the game clock to 8:58.
Coming up next, Emerald Coast Classic Championship game. Fourth ranked Iowa State and Illinois. Iowa State impressive yesterday. And then late night Toledo and Middle Tennessee in the Great Alaska Shootout. 12:30 Eastern, 7:15 is the next game, that Emerald Classic Championship game. Terrific effort by Hunter Sharp.
Hunter Sharp on the reception.
Just shy of the first down at the 40-yard line.
Yeah, I think, Rich, that Hunter Sharp is going to have a big impact here in the last part of this game if they have any shot in getting back into it. He's been the most consistent big play weapon here offensively for Utah State, and they're going to have to find a way to get the ball to him.
Second down and less than a yard. Brad Johansson and Doug Gottlieb have the call of number 4, Iowa State and Illinois. A draw. Punt to the 32-yard line.
The good news is if you're Matt Wells, that last extra point miss really helps out your football team because now you're down only 16 points instead of 17 points. And 2 two-point conversions can tie the game.
End zone shot and incomplete. Brandon Swindle.
Keaton's pass incomplete.
The intended receiver.
Second down and 10.
Matt Wells and Utah State very good here. Boise State beat him, and that's the last home loss. Of course, Wells taking over for Gary Anderson, who is now at Oregon State. Went to Wisconsin. Third year for Wells. He is 1-1 against Brigham Young. On second and 10, keeping up play action. Ball's deflected and loose and incomplete. Logan Taele got a hand up.
Yeah, they really had a hard time here on the right side. You're going to see Simonich. He grabs to L.A. because to L.A. just beats him flat off of the line of scrimmage. He had pressure inside, and, you know, Keaton doesn't even have a chance. I think, you know, this pass rush has done a really good job today, especially in this second half, getting to Keaton and not allowing any routes to develop downfield.
Looked like Simonich made the catch, actually, of the deflected ball. Third down and a punch, 15. Keaton's in trouble. Heaves it up. And it's incomplete, and that BYU pass rush again, all over. Chucky Keaton,
really has done a good job. That's Austin Heater.
Quarterback is out of pocket.
He's a backup linebacker, and he wasn't even supposed to blitz. He had coverage right there on the running back, and because he saw his back block, he came wrapped around for second contain,
and got to Keaton. And look, we've seen here in the second half, every time Keaton lines up for a drop back pass, there's been a Cougar defender in his face forcing him to get rid of the ball.
Going to go for it on fourth down and 15. Incomplete. Andrew Rodriguez, the intended receiver. And BYU's defense gets the football back. Chucky Keaton on his way to the sideline.
Just a great play by the freshman, Michael Shelton, playing inside on the nickel. Look at, he reaches that right hand in there at the last second, perfectly plays his, turns his head, and you see Keaton going down one more time. The pressure has been intense on Keaton here in that second half, but a great play by the freshman, nickelback Michael Shelton.
Now Brigham Young back with much better field position, pushed all the way out to the 37-yard line. Keep it on the ground, Algernon Brown for the 41. And obviously you need another stop. Utah State is down a couple scores. They need two touchdowns and two-point conversions.
It's unbelievable, isn't it, how this momentum just changed like that. There at the end of that half, BYU was badly getting outplayed and was down 21-10 in the first half here against Utah State. But those two big plays completely changed it, and the Aggies just haven't been able to recover.
Long count. Brown again. Flag down. Brown lands just beyond the first down marker, so he's got it at the 48. But
I think they're going to get a legal chop.
Personal foul. Chop block. Offense number 78, number 56. 15-yard penalty. Replay second down.
That's a two-man violation, isn't it?
Yes, it is. And it's the center, T. John Caroma, and the guard, Tooney Kanuch. And as, you know, you're going to see Nick Vigil come in the frame right here, and you're going to get that post and chop by that center guard combination.
One man high, one man low. Emerald Coast Classic coming up, number four, Iowa State and Illinois. 7:15 Eastern with a tip-off. Mangum scrambling, looking, lofts it up for Kurtz, and he can't hold it. Incomplete. One of the few times one of these BYU big receivers has been unable to hold on.
And we really haven't seen a lot of this, the scramble drill. You can see that Mangum was pointing to Kurtz to adjust his route and go down the field. And I thought Mangum put it in a very good place, but good job by Hines to come in there and get that ball out.
We talked about the scramble drill in the first half. It's something that BYU does in every practice, and it pays off, especially with a guy like Mangum who keeps plays alive. He throws so well on the run. Third and 19. Here comes a blitz. It's picked up. A nifty draw, but smelled out and stopped. And that was Torrey Green, senior linebacker.
It really a great job by Green. He's coming
timeout.
On a blitz.
Utah State, first charge timeout of the half.
But he recognizes, Rich, recognizes the very late delayed draw, comes out of the blitz, and makes the play.
Arch, we'd like to welcome another member to our CBS Sports team, and that is young Gwendolyn. Gwendolyn Doyle, born on the 25th, 10 pounds, 2 ounces. Congratulations to our colleague Nick and his lovely wife Gloria. First Thanksgiving.
What a cutie.
Very nice. Utah State has burned a timeout, desperate to get the football back with some clock to maneuver. And fourth and 16 will bring a punt from BYU. And a large crowd, a sellout crowd, who has been vocal for both sides. Plenty of BYU fans here. Utah State fans have been loud. Temperatures well below freezing the entire game. Rodriguez at the 30, avoids one tackle, gets to the outside, shifts into gear, and ends up out of bounds at the 48-yard line.
Rodriguez.
And a nice return. All right, Archie, you up for whatever Bud Light is. Here's the moment of the game. Final seconds, final play of the first half. Chucky Keaton scrambling. Tomasi Lalile picks it up and takes it in for the score. That is the biggest play of the ballgame.
Huge play, completely changed it and gave BYU a great boost of energy going into halftime. And then, boy, they came out here in that second half and just have flat out gotten after it.
Now Utah State trying to run the football and slipping his punt. Keeps the clock rolling.
Now I think, Rich, I think you got to go to a pure passing game right now. I don't know if you're going to get a chance to really get anything going on the ground against this defense. You're down two touchdowns, less than 6 minutes left in the game. Your only choice, your only chance is for Keaton to start airing it out every play.
Flags down. Keaton's going to scramble. This play may come back. Keaton gets to the sidelines. He's going to stop the clock with the flag. And let's see if it was a hold. That's where the flag usually sits.
Personal foul. Chop block. Offense. Number 65, number 21. 15-yard penalty. Replay second down.
Austin Albrecht and Luan Hunt flagged.
See 21 here. And yeah, you can see he goes down. Longy doesn't actually go to the ground. I thought that one was pretty iffy. But Longy was engaged with Albrecht and Hunt did go down. So I guess technically, Rich, that is a chop, but pretty close.
A massive penalty. Second and 25. Short throw. And it skips by Braylon Roberts. Number four, Iowa State. Jameel McKay had 23 in the win over Virginia Tech. He'll take on Illinois. Brad Johansson, Doug Gottlieb. The Emerald Coast Classic Championship game. More movement, more flags. Bronco Mendenhall playing an ambitious schedule this year. If you think this year's schedule is ambitious, next year's schedule for BYU is incredible. And, you know, you really have to admire Brigham Young and their head coach because they've talked the talk.
Number 76 in the offense, 5-yard penalty, third down.
They've talked the talk about wanting to get to a Power 5 conference, and they're more than walking the walk with their schedule.
Yeah, absolutely. Look at their opponents. I mean, this is a big-time schedule. And you know, quite honestly, Rich, I think college football has to go to more with that. Today in this climate of college football, there's nothing worse than a tremendous mismatch. And I think, you ought to go out there and play against the best competition every single week. So I wish more teams would take BYU's lead. I know they can't because of their conference obligations, but I love the ambitious nature of BYU going out there and playing the best.
Well, everyone except maybe the coaches' wives, because when the schedule was released, Bronco Mendenhall got a text from his wife, Holly, and said, "This is awful." And I guess the lesson is that it's not Jerry Palm or some computer or the college football playoff that determines strength of schedule. It's the coaches' families who have a much better gauge on what is a difficult schedule.
That's what a good wife is supposed to do. But still, I love it. I wish, you know, I get irritated with the scheduling.
Sharp. And he's blocked off. It's incomplete. Utah State going on 4th and 31. Brigham Young gets the football. We go back to New York and Brent Stover. Brent?
Guys, you just mentioned it. We're going to head out to the Emerald Coast Classic Championship game on Iowa State's first possession. able to knock one in. Fourth-ranked Iowa State leading Illinois 2-0. 1 minute deep. We'll head out to Brad Johansson and Doug Gottlieb as soon as you guys are done.
All right, thank you, Brent. Yeah, number four, Iowa State looked really good last night in the semifinals. First to 10, BYU. There's still 5 minutes left in this football game. Algernon Brown keeps it on the ground to the 20. From hoops to hockey, diamond to the gridiron. Morning's most outrageous team has you covered. Ole Miss Boomer and Carton. Weekday morning starting 6 Eastern only on CBS Sports Network. The story of this game, momentum in an enormous shift. 21-10 lead for Utah State. Brigham Young using some big plays, momentum plays, to reel off 28 consecutive points.
Big part, you're right, Rich. But also, this defense came out, BYU's did, after halftime, and has smothered Chucky Keaton and the Utah State offense. They have done an outstanding job regrouping at the half.
Longy back in, his third carry. He's to the 19-yard line. Harvey Longy, part of a very good Brigham Young defense. Both these teams have very good defenses. Bronco Mendenhall, that's been a trademark of his. And here at Utah State, traditionally their defense has been outstanding.
And the one thing that he said when we talked to him about the defense and their development this season is the fact that they found out early in the season that they had to scale things back. The players, they weren't playing fast enough, and they weren't playing understanding what they were supposed to do. And once they took the volume out of the defensive playbook, guys started making plays. They started flying around. And I think today, especially here in the second half, this is a defense that has a chance to be dominant.
Algie Brown with the carry. And on fourth and one, if Brigham Young can kick a field goal, then it pushes it past two scores and makes it a 19-point game. Or they can just go for the first down and try to keep the clock rolling.
Utah State's dangerous. They can block kicks as well. And so I think it's a little bit risky here to attempt a field goal. I like going for it and trying to put this game away.
Bang is going to throw. And open, it's Brown. He's in. Touchdown. 17 yards. And Brigham Young putting the finishing touches on an impressive win on a chilly day here in Logan.
Love the play call, Rich. Fourth and one, you put Brown in a three-point stance. You hide him behind that big offensive line, and everybody up inside gearing to try and stop a short yardage run, and Brown sneaks out. Nobody accounts for him in the passing game, and an easy touchdown to put this thing out.
The kick is good, and Brigham Young's lead is now 51-28 with 3 minutes left here in Logan, Utah. And for BYU, 9-3 is just 5 minutes away. They will have won 7 of their last 8. And Bronco Mendenhall can thank a defense that stiffened right around the middle of the game. And those big wide receivers who made play after play today.
Big story in the offense. And Mitch Matthews started things off with 2 big plays down the field. And the thing that you just love to see, whether it's Matthews or Blackman or Kurtz, going up and competing for the football and completely taking away the ball from those Utah State defensive backs. So there's a reason why 4 wide receivers have over 500 yards receiving on this football team, and Mangum is able to spread it around. They come through in a major way and are very consistent for their quarterback.
Bowl destinations for Brigham Young: the Las Vegas Bowl or Hawaii, or the Hawaii Bowl. Where it will be much warmer, you would expect, in Hawaii and even in Las Vegas. Temperatures headed back down into the low 20s, into the teens, before the night is done. Hunter Sharp to the 29-yard line. Let's go back to New York and Brent Stover. Brent?
Updating you on that Emerald Coast Classic Championship game. George Niang has all five for Iowa State so far, but for Illinois, Kendrick Nunn makes it 5-2 there. Mike Thorne Jr. makes it 7-5 here. 7-5, first half. Early on, we'll get out there as soon as you guys are done.
Doug Gottlieb very impressed with Niang last night. And then effort for the Cyclones, who traveled quite well down into Florida for that holiday tournament. They always seem to travel well, Iowa State. First and 10. Keaton's throw is dropped. And I guess now we can start talking about the legacy of Chucky Keaton. The dynamite first 2 years, the devastating knee injuries the next two seasons, another knee this year, a sprain knocked him out in the middle part of the season. It's meant so much to this program, even when he's not been on the field. Hunt, a terrific hit. Jordan Prater coming up and making that hit.
That's a fumble.
Ball's loose. BYU has it. Another turnover.
Yep.
Rolling on the field is a catch. Fumble recovered by the defense. BYU ball, first down.
Adam Archuleta, this looked like you in the day.
Oh, man. These cats for BYU are just... they are flying around. Now, Utah State wants this game to end as quickly as possible, but Prater comes in and puts a lick on Hunt. This Cougar defense is just feeling it right now. What a difference in a half of football.
Fred Warner picked it up. And Chucky Keaton still playing, made sure that Warner didn't score. And how sweet does this have to feel if you're Brigham Young? Last year it was Matt Wells in Utah State that went into Bronco Mendenhall's house and stunned everybody. An undefeated BYU team was rising up the top 25. They had a Heisman Trophy quarterback in Taysom Hill, and it all ended in that game. Utah State with a 35-20 win. Adam Hine gets his first carry of the ball game. We told you about the two ball tie-ins. Now the BYU basketball team will be over in Hawaii for Christmas during that time, and so it would be a nice Christmas for the Kafusi family, because Bronson is the star defensive end, sure to go high in the NFL draft. His father Steve, the defensive line coach, and Corbin Kafusi is a star on that BYU basketball team. And they're running clock right now. We want to take time to thank all the people behind the scenes this season. Steve Karasik, Vice President of Remote Production. Todd Carrot, our coordinating producer back in New York. Bruce Clark, our fearless leader, our producer. John Coleman, our director. Kush, Matt Kushner, our associate director. Peter Rizzo, broadcast associate. Brad Krieger, ops producer. Monty Poling, technical director. Craig Kaufman, EVS. Matt Weaver on audio. Jen Lorenz on duets. Phil Bonilla on the score bug. Scott Snell, our traveling cameraman. Fearless, along with our Cassie Gallo, certainly. Nate Gardner, Danny Stone, our engineers. Randy Boggs, mobile unit driver. And the always spectacular Len Fink, support operations. We live a charmed life, Adam Archuleta, along with Cassie Gallo. The men and women behind the camera, in the truck, and back in New York, work tirelessly. Here we are in a heated booth, albeit a temporary one. Getting paid to watch football. Can Bronco smile was the sign in the first half. A little bit of a grin. BYU, for the first time since 2011, is at 9 wins. They are 9-3.
Yeah, how many times, Rich, did we hear the number 9 mentioned in our call with the coaching staff and the players? Every answer to every question was saying, we're just looking for number 9. Number 9. And that was the repetitive theme, the repetitive mantra. I got to tell you, it didn't look very good there in that first half, but boy, the resiliency and the way they came back and dominated after halftime was an impressive performance.
Robert Adnai, the offensive coordinator, has to be pretty pleased. Tony Lindsay with the carry for Utah State. He's going to scamper out of bounds with 28 seconds left. You know, BYU's in a tough spot trying to get into the college playoff discussion. Not necessarily a group of five, not necessarily a power five. But the schedule they've played, they're at 9-3. They've got an even better schedule next season. They're going to be a handful for anybody that runs into them in either Las Vegas or Hawaii.
And they got a quarterback who's young and has a very bright future and a lot of snaps left to guide this football team.
And just one senior on a talented offensive line as well. And of course, a deep roster of big play receivers. They're going to go get the wheel. They play for the wagon wheel, and it goes back to BYU. Bronson Kafusi, Tanner Mangum, and BYU victorious. Let's go to Brad Johansson, Doug Gottlieb in Florida. It's the Emerald Coast Classic Championship game, number 4 Iowa State and Illinois. For Anna Archuleta, Cassie Gallo, I'm Rich Waltz. Take it away, Brad. 51-28, the final here.